rock.
She was giving him the business.
Two of the greatest voices in country music.
They were my favorites.
Put country music duets on the chart.
Favorite duet of all time.
Doesn't get any cooler than that.
They just connected on this crazy level.
That's what makes a great duet.
Greatest Duets.
Well, you're the reason I've changed to beer from soda pop.
And you're the reason I never get to go to the beauty shop.
By 1978, Conway Twitty and Loretta Lynn had been at the top of the country duet world for nearly a decade.
Conway and Loretta were so hot.
It's hard to beat those two.
They could do anything, and it was just great.
And you're the reason I can't
You're the reason our kids are ugly. That, to me, is the greatest title of any song I've ever heard.
That sounds like something Loretta for sure would do.
This is a very complicated emotion. It's like I'm blaming you for our kids' genetics, but I still love you.
I think every once in a while we need a song like that that makes everybody laugh and just feel good.
But meanwhile, the children are victims. They're miserable. They're really ugly.
There's a talking part at the end where she's telling him to get up off the couch.
You can tell that they were having a good time with this.
When you have fun in the studio like that and that comes across, it just makes the song better.
You're the reason our kids are ugly.
Nothing says I love you like you're the reason our kids are ugly. Now that's a love song.
You never looked better than tonight.
In 1980, Kenny Rogers asked Kim Carnes and her songwriter husband Dave Ellingson to write a concept album for him called Gideon.
When we got to Dreamer, he stopped it and said, well, if I do this whole album, will you sing Dreamer with me as a duet?
Kim and I sound like we're hemorrhaging the whole time we're singing. You know, we're just full throat, both of us.
I really felt great about the whole project and the way that that particular song came out.
In 1991, 2 years after the untimely death of country star Keith Whitley, RCA released Brotherly Love, a powerful duet that paired Whitley with legend Earl Thomas Conway.
He's my all-time favorite singer of any form of music. Earl Thomas Conway is it for me.
Keith Whitley's voice, I mean, big, big baritone voice.
What a good guy and a great talent.
It really broke my heart when Keith died. I just really thought he had one of the best unique country voices I'd heard in a long time.
We recorded it and then RCA put it away for 3 or 4 years. Meantime, Keith passed away and they came out with it and they went to number one.
Great song, and Keith and ETC just wore it out too. They sang their butts off on that song.
They really sounded like brothers on this song.
Sometimes there's a record that just has some kind of magic to it, and that has it from start to finish. It's brotherly love.
And now, who would you like to duet with?
Piece of cake, Marty Robbins.
I would love to do a duet with Merle Haggard.
Maybe Little Richard.
Merle Haggard would be a good duet partner.
Alison Krauss.
I always wanted to do one with Sammy Davis Jr.
Alison Krauss.
Probably would be Dolly.
Keith Urban. I'll probably do something with Keith.
Martina McBride.
Another person that I would love to sing with that I never have is Patti Loveless.
Oh, I'd pick Ann Murray.
Shania for obvious reasons.
Always Billy Gilman, man. That's top of my list. Every time I can think of anything, it's
You're
Billy Gilman.
You're absolutely right. You and him could sing the high parts.
Yeah.
Dizzy got the oodles and
Texas, I'm going home to see the other men held her.
The Yellow Rose of Texas dates back to 1836. It was a popular folk song during the battle for Texas independence.
Yellow Rose is always here when you come home again.
In 1984, Lane Brody was hired to sing it as the theme for a primetime soap on NBC. She rewrote the lyrics and chose Johnny Lee as her partner.
You saved my soul from hell.
Urban cowboy comes to town, and it's pretty obvious. There's a big old hit.
She's a yellow rose in Texas. She can make a man a king.
We sang our hearts out and still get tons of mail from all over the world. The Yellow Rose is a favorite of so many people, and I'm grateful for it.
Man a king. It's a yellow rose in Texas.
When Trisha Yearwood teamed up with R&B funk superstar Aaron Neville in 1994, they had big shoes to fill. They were re-recording a classic song made famous by country's greatest female vocalist, the legendary Patsy Cline.
It's so hard as an artist to go back and recut a song that was such a big hit.
There are two of us. So we could team up on it, you know.
You want me tonight, like we never kissed.
It was almost like you were hearing the song for the first time.
It's like country and soul are the same thing, but the best soul and the best country reach the same place.
I'm glad they asked me to do it, you know.
Dolly Parton joined the Porter Wagoner Show as the girl singer. It began a hugely successful partnership that would last nearly a decade.
Porter and I started out, I guess, 1966 together. And we had, it was like a brother-sister voice. It was like family harmonies.
For I couldn't make it alone.
Porter and Dolly together were just amazing. I mean, they were absolutely amazing.
Those personalities were so big that they jumped off the screen. I could just see that they enjoyed singing together so much on TV.
And when I'm in darkness, you bring me the light.
She is just a real great person to be around. She will inspire you, whatever you're doing.
Dolly and Porter inspired each other both on camera and off. They wrote many of their hits together, including the 1974 chart topper, Please Don't Stop Loving Me.
That one just started coming out one night, traveling on the bus like so many of them did. We either would work up songs or write songs when we traveled around. And boy, we just started singing that one. It just came rolling out.
When things go all wrong, you make me all right.
We just thought that song really good. So we just singing it really good.
Don't stop.
Black went on tour with fellow country superstar Wynonna in the summer of 1993. He rewrote his poignant ballad, A Bad Goodbye, as a duet. It became a highlight of their wildly successful Black and Y tour.
It was one of those spine-tingling moments where, you know, something special was happening. Stage, she'd come out during my show, and the crowd would go nuts.
It was probably one of the highlights of my life because things were going so well.
That was one of the best tours I've had, and it'd be great to do that again.
Goodbye.
Coming up in the studio with Glenn and Tanya.
Whenever the restraining order wasn't happening, they were loud within mic distance.
I gotta be honest, I don't even remember recording that song.
She ain't got a lot of common sense, but boy, she can sing.
And later, Guitar Gods Unite.
I think both of them
you know, only ever sang because they had to.
It's a master clinic for guitarists.
But first, who was the first husband and wife duet couple to win CMA Male and Female Vocalist Awards in the same year? George and Tammy, Tim and Faith, Johnny and June, or Chris and Rita? Find out the hot couple when CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns.
CMT's 100 Greatest Duets is brought to you by Olive Garden, Starbucks Frappuccino, and Claritin Allergy Products.
So, where are you going to go from here?
Probably the penne with meat sauce. Fettuccine with Alfredo?
I meant with your leg.
It's Olive Garden's never-ending pasta bowl with great new sauces like mushroom Alfredo and creamy five cheese marinara. Pick one combination of sauce and pasta, then another. Have all you want, just $7.95. Plus, of course, salad and breadsticks.
I'm in a really good place right now, Dad.
At Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
Yeah, Stuart, I know. I got it.
Oh, here's your mail. This too.
Diane, your dog bit the neighbor again.
Frank's freaking out about something.
Diane, this color coding system has color, but it has no code.
If an account can vote in either blue or yellow.
Delicious Starbucks Frappuccino coffee drink. It's you time.
I can get so congested from my allergies that I feel like I'm not all there. But I've still got to report the story.
So I found Claritin D and got Claritin Clear. That means I'm getting non-drowsy relief and doing my job.
Clock, you're on.
If you want long-lasting relief from your worst congestion, sinus pressure, and itchy eyes without getting drowsy, nothing is stronger or faster than Claritin D. It's the one that works for my allergies and my life. Non-drowsy Claritin D.
Live Claritin Clear.
Every once in a while, I like to mix it up. Throw in a little twist. Be a little more playful. That's why I love the new Pantene Curls collection. Curls are hot. Every hairstyle says something different. What do my curls say to me? They go boing. There's something for every look you can imagine. I don't know if it's the provitamin formula or what.
I can go curly, I can go wavy, I can kind of do it all.
The new Pantene Curls collection.
I love it.
Hair color looking dull? Turn it up to Garnier 100% Color. 100% color equals maximum color, maximum shine. Color pigments grab on, hold on, and it really lasts. Garnier 100% Color. Why settle for less?
Garnier.
Dry weave is softer than ever, and it helps keep you dry. Because if you're gonna sit on it all day, it better be comfortable. Have a happy period. Always.
It's the album that debuted at number one on the country chart. From the top-selling debut country artist of 2005, Miranda Lambert, Kerosene. Featuring her hot new single, Bring Me Down. Miranda Lambert Kerosene features 12 songs in all. Including the title track and her debut hit, Me and Charlie Talking. Miranda Lambert Kerosene. Call or log on now to order Miranda Lambert's Kerosene. Get your copy today.
Who was the first married duet couple to walk away with both CMA Male and Female Vocalist Awards in the same year? Believe it or not, it was Tim and Faith in 2000.
They were close to a hat trick, but their nominated duet, Let's Make Love, lost out to Alan and George's Murder on Music Row.
Tell me about it. Tell me about teardrops in the dark.
I remember hearing that for the first time, thinking, this rocks, it's awesome.
1992's Tell Me About It paired country music's Wild Child with juke joint blues king Delbert McClinton.
She's got such a lust for life.
Just get ready, we're coming.
Come closer and tell me about.
He is truly a great, great singer.
It's like he eats a pound of gravel before he goes on the stage.
We sang it together, looking right at each other.
And if you can stand there and look each other in the face when you're singing, it's going to be better.
It's so cool when you can, you know, breathe your onions on each other. We were really good. We were really good. I'm proud of that. Really proud.
Old friends.
Songwriting legend Roger Miller wrote Old Friends as a way to honor his mother and father.
Till it's dark. Old friends.
In 1981, Roger suggested the song to Willie Nelson as a part of their duet album, giving the lyrics a nostalgic twist.
Swapping lives of lives and loves, pitching popcorn to the doves, old friends.
Old friends, I mean, those guys have been friends since before time, you know. And I think it was great that they did that together.
That song is more like two guys talking and getting together than it was like a song, because they're good buddies, and it felt like that.
When I'm hearing them two singing, I'm wondering if they're smirking at each other. Because you know there's 10,000 different stories between the two. Just to be around them together, it was just so comforting, because it was like they had it all in control for all of us. They're both such cosmic guys.
Oh, friend.
Thank you, Will.
In 1970, Glenn Campbell and Bobby Gentry got into the top 10 with their cover of All I Have to Do Is Dream, a 1958 number one hit for the Everly Brothers.
Anytime one of their songs is remade, you know, you can't do without that other harmony.
Bobby, our voices blended so well together.
Glenn Campbell is one of the best musician singers of all time, and at that time Bobby Gentry, she was huge.
After Ode to Billy Joe, I mean, she just had a touch with her voice that was magic.
Everybody can relate to it, loved it, and great idea to redo that song.
Singing with Bobby Gentry was really a thrill. Hi Bobby, I hope you're watching.
And now, a great CMT Crossroads moment.
Anytime you get a chance to work with somebody that has influenced you, it's always a great thing.
This guy has got his own sound.
Of all the people that I listened to growing up, he probably had as much or more influence on the way I sing as anybody.
I don't even remember recording that song.
I guess she's really trying to forget.
You know, there are a lot of things about that those years I don't remember too well.
Well, this duet was on Glenn Campbell's album called It's the World Gone Crazy.
Glenn Campbell, Tanya Tucker, two crazy people. There's always a lot of drama.
Whenever the restraining order wasn't happening, they were loud within mic distance. Did some pretty, pretty cool stuff.
I'd say it was just a darn good day if you could get them both in the studio on their feet to record.
With Glenn, you know, we cut a lot of great songs together.
She ain't got a lot of common sense, but boy, she can sing.
Almost a decade before George and Tammy, there was George and Melba.
I'm much more of a fan of the records he made with Melba Montgomery.
Melba Montgomery and George Jones singing together is one of the most righteous sounds that you will ever hear.
All we must have been out of our mind.
Melba wrote this heartfelt duet in 1962, and it started a string of five top 40 hits for the hardcore honky-tonk duo.
Well, I just started singing it, George just fell right in. It was just like it was meant to be.
She was a real country singer, real traditional sound and everything like myself.
I always just felt it, it came from the heart.
In 1989, country legend Buck Owens and former Beatle Ringo Starr teamed up for a duet of a song they'd each had a huge hit with separately. And all they had to do was act naturally.
I thought it was pretty cool that they got Ringo and Buck together to do a remake of it. After all, Ringo did sing the Beatles version, which was a hit.
To have these guys who, you know, we're by then living legends, get together and sing a song.
Buck Owens and a Beatle together, it was just so great.
Ringo's a pretty good singer, you know, for a drummer.
They just look like they're having a blast.
This is like a celebration between both of them.
It doesn't get any cooler than that.
Clint Eastwood gets help from his barroom buddy Merle.
To fully appreciate Clint's performance in this song, it is advisable to chug-a-lug a lot before listening to it.
I told him, I said, you know, I'll stay completely out of film if you'll promise to not sing again.
And later, a grown-up look at relationships.
It was kind of like a weird combination at first.
I've heard duets where people got mashed up that just didn't work. That would work.
But first, why did Porter Wagoner and Dolly Parton begin singing duets together? Was it because Dolly was popular with the fans, Porter was sick and couldn't sing solo, Dolly was unpopular with the fans, or Porter liked Dolly's wigs? The answer when CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns.
Log on to CMT.com for more of CMT's 100 Greatest Duets. Flip through photos, see artist interviews, and get the latest info and TV listings only at CMT.com. She has been called the most complete and gifted female singer of her generation. Now, CMT brings you two decades of hits and new songs in an exclusive, intimate performance. CMT presents Winona, Her Story.
It's live, baby.
Her Story premieres Friday at 9, 8 Central, only on CMT.
It's a revolutionary step in CoverGirl makeup. Outlast makeup with its own primer. Step one, the primer creates a smooth canvas. So two, the color lasts 50% longer. Outlast makeup from Easy Breezy Beautiful CoverGirl.
Fed up with forgettable color?
Turn it up to Garnier 100% Color. 100% color equals maximum color, maximum shine. Here's why.
Pure color pigments grab on, hold on.
Does it really last?
Pump up your color, max out your shine.
Turn it up to 100%.
Maximum color, maximum shine.
Garnier 100% color. Why settle for less?
Garnier.
Yeah, Stuart, I know. I got it.
Oh, here's your mail. This too.
Diane, your dog bit the neighbor again.
Frank's freaking out about something.
Diane, this color coding system has color, but it has no color.
I'm gonna count them.
Either blue or yellow.
Delicious Starbucks Frappuccino coffee drink. It's you time.
You gelling?
No telling how much I'm gelling.
You gelling?
You know I'm gelling.
Hey, Ellen, you gelling?
I'm gelling. You want some melon?
Nah, but hey, I'm like mud gelling. I'm so gelling.
Are you gelling yet? Dr. Scholl's massaging gel insoles are made from the softest gel ever created. If you and your shoes don't feel outrageously comfortable, you get your money back. Guaranteed.
I'm gelling.
You're not gelling.
You're so not gelling.
Are you gelling? Dr. Scholl's.
So, where are you going to go from here?
Probably the penne with meat sauce. Fettuccine with Alfredo?
I meant with your leg.
It's Olive Garden's never-ending pasta bowl with great new sauces like mushroom Alfredo and creamy five-cheese marinara. Pick one combination of sauce and pasta, then another. Have all you want, just $7.95. Plus, of course, salad and breadsticks.
I'm in a really good place right now, Dad.
At Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
On September 27th, get ready.
It used to be a lot worse. They had this giant hammer.
To join the party.
Yeah, baby!
And celebrate with the coolest DVD of the year.
Yahoo!
Robin Williams is back.
Ta-da!
You missed a spot.
Get out of my room!
I'm not in your room.
I am now.
No, I'm not.
I am not amped.
From the creators of Ice Age.
Who wants to get fixed?
Robots on DVD September 27th.
Fix my neck!
Metamucil presents The Regulars.
Bob.
Red. Jack.
Bob.
Red. Jack.
Bob.
Red. Jack.
If you want to be one of the regulars,
Bob.
Red. Jack.
Take Metamucil Daily Fiber every day to stay regular the natural way.
Why did Porter Wagoner and Dolly Parton begin singing duets together? The answer? Dolly was unpopular with the fans. When Dolly joined Porter's show in 1966, she had replaced Norma Jean as Porter's girl singer. Fans didn't like the change, and when Dolly first appeared, the audience shouted, "We want Norma Jean." To ease the tension, Porter suggested singing duets.
Who's gonna take your garbage out when I pack my bags and go?
Before there was Conway, there was Ernest. Loretta Lynn's duet career began with her childhood idol, country legend Ernest Tubb.
Ernest Tubb, as far as I was concerned when I was a little girl, he was the only one I could really remember on the Grand Ole Opry.
I loved Ernest Tubb. I think he's somebody that paved the way for all of us. And then in Loretta with him, you can't get any countryer than that.
He was a big star at the time, taking this young fledgling, pure as the driven snow artist.
I know you think I'm running around, and that's why you're so peeved.
Well, that's another line of the same old stuff that I hope you don't expect me to believe.
Who's Gonna Take the Garbage Out became Loretta and Ernest's fourth and final hit at the end of 1969.
Tell me that, honey. Who's gonna take your garbage out when I pack my bags and go?
And somebody does have to take the garbage out.
Honey, who's gonna take your garbage out when I pack my bags and go? You're gonna miss me, honey. Yeah.
I got a song pitched to me by Nancy Montgomery, songwriter here in Nashville.
She said, "This song is for you. I'm telling you, this is for y'all. I wrote it thinking about you guys."
She knew us very well and knew how we loved each other and knew about our marriage and our relationship, and it just seemed to be the perfect fit.
I know them. I know them well. And they mean this song. This song, it kind of defines who and what they are as a couple.
The made-to-order duet for Sharon and Ricky was nominated for a CMA award in 1987. Sharon had been nominated several times as a member of the Whites, but had never won.
So I figured it'd be another one of those nights of just sitting there hearing them call somebody else's name.
Well, I remember that night so clear when they called our name.
Ricky Skaggs and Sharon White.
I'm so proud for you. That's great.
Oh, God.
I was happy for us, but I was so happy for her because she is such a great singer.
I've always wondered what I would say
I'm going to start good enough words to tell you.
It was a major thrill, and to get to do it with Ricky was a big deal to me.
When they say love can't get better than this one, you can pretty well believe them.
In the summer of 1953, the little-known duo of Gene Shepherd and Ferlin Husky released a song that resonated throughout the country. A Dear John letter was a tearjerker about a soldier in battle who's jilted by his beloved.
The Korean War had just ended, so it was a very timely song.
The gist of it is he's overseas in battle, and he gets the letter.
And tonight I'll wed another Dear John.
I don't know how many guys have walked up and says, boy, I got me a Dear John letter.
Who has not gotten Dear John letters? And they always come at the worst freaking possible time. Like, I'm dealing with this, and you want to send me that.
Will you please send back my picture?
Not only is she in love with somebody else, it happens to be his brother.
Now the ceremony has started, and I'll wed your brother, Don.
Oh, and footnote. It's your brother. Yeah, okay. Catch you when you get back. Bye. Have a great time at the war.
Well, that's a tearjerker if I ever heard one.
And now, Mark Chestnut goes one-on-one with the possum.
I was in the studio working on my second album, and then we asked George if he'd come in and do a song called Talking to Hank. And the only thing I was nervous about is that when we did the vocals for the song, we were actually face-to-face. I thought that was the coolest thing, actually looking at George Jones face to face. And he likes to do that when he sings. He likes to look at you. And that kind of shakes you up a little bit when George Jones is looking at you and his eyes are getting big.
I got goosebumps and pickles and feel kind of faint.
And then when you're singing back to him, he's looking at you like, all right, son, now what do you got? It's like a competition kind of thing, which I lost.
When two superpowers collide, the result can be a phenomenon of success, or it can be catastrophic. And sometimes, it's both. Like when Merle Haggard and Clint Eastwood teamed up to sing Barroom Buddies in 1981.
Hey, I wanna sing till the feeling gets right.
Well, let's harmonize, we'll be dynamite.
These are two icons of American culture.
I think the duet's a classic.
Yeah. And he sounds like Dirty Harry singing.
Yeah, and you always let her know just who you are. You know,
the good, bad, and the ugly.
I want to watch Click act. Don't want to hear him sing.
Well, we're barroom buddies, and that's the best kind.
Well, buddy fools with a buddy of mine. You know?
I mean, it's just make my day.
I told him, I said, you know, I'll stay completely out of film if you'll promise to not sing him yet.
I laugh when you're happy, and I cry when you're blue.
To fully appreciate Clint's performance in this song, it is advisable to chug-a-lug a lot before listening to it.
Chug-a-lug-a-lug an old barroom buddy of mine.
In 1990, Tanya Tucker was looking for a partner to record a cover duet of Don't Go Out. The call went to T. Graham Brown.
So I said, what song? They said, Don't Go Out. I said, yeah, I love this song. I know it.
Baby, you're headed for a brand new heartache. Don't go out with him.
Gosh, T. Graham just sang his rear end off on that song. Truly one of my favorite singers in the world. He's got some soul that all the way down to his toes, you know.
We were ready, man. I don't think either one of us hold back anyway.
I would love to do some more music with T. Graham Brown.
In 1979, Willie Nelson and Ray Price agreed to record a duet album. A year went by when suddenly Willie asked Ray to fly to Nashville. Ray grabbed a red eye, and before the night was over, the two Hall of Famers had recorded one of their favorite songs, the Bob Wills classic, Faded Love.
When I got through it, dawned on me why he did it on that day. It was my birthday, so it's kind of a gift from him.
It's ended up being
an enduring song, and it was a present to everyone.
The melody and how the harmonies just seem to flow so easily.
Both of us had been singing it for years, being from Texas and playing all the joints and everything.
They were kind of born to do that song together, you know, in my opinion.
Ray is country music's Tony Bennett. That's how I think of him.
As I read the lines that to me were so sweet.
That voice with Willie was sort of an odd, you know, combination, but it was perfect. It's a great record.
It's great. Put my fanny back to work real big time.
Coming up, Murray Osmond and Dan Seals head out west.
You know, I really love it when a song can take you somewhere you've never been.
You just want to turn the wheel west and head towards Montana, you know.
And later, two party boys celebrate the honky-tonk life.
There was an energy on stage, a chemistry on stage that worked.
It's about winding up at the goal line at the other end of the show with a ball in your hand going, we did all right.
But first, which one of Willie Nelson's duet partners was the first person to sign his famous guitar? Was it Waylon Jennings, Leon Russell, Ray Price, or Merle Haggard? We'll give you the answer when CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns.
I dropped a quarter, played Golden Rain on the jukebox.
The show's over, but Gretchen still wants to play.
If you're waiting on me, you're backing up.
The real music happens backstage.
Hey, friend, he thought she could dirty dance to her.
They're the hits you haven't heard yet.
Cause I'm one but wise.
Gretchen Wilson, Undressed. Saturday at 9, 8 Central on CMT.
What the hell was that?
At your age, a good night's sleep is important. New Pampers Baby Dry absorbs better overnight than Huggies Baby Shape Fit. Rise and shine and absorb even more. New Pampers Baby Dry.
It's the stick it where it hurts to feel well. Patch works in a hurry to feel well. Patch lasts a long time to feel well. Well Patch, it brings you back to well, Patch.
Whatever your pain, Well Patch brings you back to well.
Psst, hey, hey, we need to talk.
What's up?
What's up? You're hogging the family again.
We love it out here.
You're already the cooking, heating, hot water guy, but now outside? Aren't you spreading yourself a wee bit thin?
Not at all. Hey, why don't you join us out here?
What? And end up like wood?
I'm too smart for that.
Turn your yard into an outdoor family room with propane and add value to your home. Learn more at usepropane.com.
Experienced agent to take on the job and make your life a whole lot simpler.
Paper cut.
Yeah.
Let's stick with Remax.
Nobody sells more real estate than Remax.
He teaches high school geography in Tucson. She's a mom, balancing work and what's for dinner. And this is Take On Orbitz, the game that pits other travel services against Orbitz.com.
Today's contestants need a 4-star hotel in Manhattan near Central Park. Ready? Go. That new Orbitz neighborhood matrix makes it easy to find the right hotel.
Next time, Orbitz.
And go!
BK is making NFL history. Now every Angus rapper scores a free day of NFL Sunday Ticket from DirecTV.
This is a dishwasher. This is not. This is Cascade Complete. It's 30% better at breaking down tough food than whatever you're using. Because pre-washing is our job, not yours. Cascade Complete. Now that's clean.
This is Bob. Bob is doing well. Very well indeed. That's because not long ago, with just a quick phone call, Bob realized that he could have something better in his life. And what did he get? Why, a big boost of confidence, a little more self-esteem, and a very happy missus at home. Call or go online now to get a free sample pack. Enzyte, the once daily tablet for natural male enhancement. This is Bob. Bob is looking cool. And with a call to Enzyte about natural male enhancement, Bob is living large. In a few short weeks, Bob has a big new spring of confidence, a generous swelling of pride, and the one thing every man deserves, a little well-earned respect from the neighborhood. Call or go online now to get a free sample pack of Enzyte. Enzyte, the once daily tablet for natural male enhancement.
Which one of Willie's duet partners was the first person to sign his famous guitar? The honor went to Leon Russell. The guitar, named Trigger by Willie, now bears hundreds of famous signatures and remains one of Willie's most prized possessions.
There's no better duet to me than when you see somebody getting to perform with one of their heroes.
Poor Boy Blues won a 1990 Grammy for guitar gods Chet Atkins and Mark Knopfler. Yes, they're singing, but this duet is about the picking.
I think both of them, you know, only ever sang because they had to.
Mark Knopfler is basically as famous a guitarist as is living today in the rock world. It shows you that they have true reverence for guys like Chet Atkins.
Chet is, as anyone that's ever held a guitar's hero.
He was the best guitar player in the world, literally bar none.
It's a master clinic for guitarists.
Trip Around the Sun is not only an interesting take on looking back at the year past, it's also a unique recording from Margaritaville's favorite son of a sailor, Jimmy Buffett, and perennial female vocalist of the year, Martina McBride.
I couldn't believe that one. It was kind of like a weird combination at first.
What's so neat about Martina's contribution to the song, it's not typical Martina.
She holds the reins and gives a beautiful and mature performance that really complements his voice as well.
Yes, I'll make a resolution.
I've heard duets where people got mashed up that just didn't work. That one worked.
Rodney Crowell and Roseanne Cash were Nashville's glamour couple when their duet It's Such a Small World became the first of five number one hits off Rodney's 1988 Diamonds and Dirt album.
That duet was just an extension of the duet that they had in their lives.
It's just a great little tribute to that love story that played out relatively quickly but left in its wake many great records.
It's like a document of a time in my life that was fun, and we had a great time together.
It was fireworks, it was emotion, it was pain, angst, love, all mixed into the record.
I loved it. And then we made this very sexy video that continues to embarrass my children to the day. We just had a lot of fun all the way around with that song.
Now, Andy Griggs reflects on his favorite duet.
I was driving down, I just got my driver's license, and I heard Brotherly Love, Earl Thomas Conley, and the late Keith Whitley. When I was driving down the road, I had my brother with me, and me and him listened to it, and every line in it, that was me and my brother. And within a year, my brother passed away. So when I hear that song, if I'm not alone, I turn it off. I can only hear that song alone, because I don't know if I'm going to laugh or I don't know if I'm going to cry. Here's me and Earl Thomas Conley still on planet Earth, and Keith and my brother singing it up in heaven.
In 1972, Kris Kristofferson was the toast of Music City when he bumped into sultry folk rock star Rita Coolidge.
I was on the way back to Nashville, and I ran into Rita. We hooked up on the plane, and she got off Memphis, and I got off with her.
The pair married in 1973 and let loose with a string of hit albums and won a Grammy for this upbeat performance of A Down-and-Outer's Tale.
That would have been new romantic love doing that first record together. We were stoked. Did you ever see a down-and-outer waking up alone without a blanket on to keep you from the dew?
They were so romantic, you know?
It was almost like the Woodstock era, Kris and Rita.
We were so in love, and it was great.
In 1995, 13-year-old Leanne Rimes was recording her debut album. The B-side of her breakout single, Blue, was an unlikely duet of a 1944 hit made famous by a country pop legend 65 years her senior.
And they were picking some songs to record, and she said to him, I want to sing a cattle call. Well, Mike says, well, would you like to sing it with the guy that used to sing it?
He rides in the sun till his day's work is done, and he rounds up the cattle each fall.
Cattle Call's lyrical images of the Old West are enhanced by a distinctive cowboy yodel, a talent not easy to come by.
It's early. I don't know how they do that.
It helps if the two people can harmonize.
In 1985, it had been over a dozen years since Marie Osmond had a hit record. Her first country hit, Paper Roses, made history as the first time a female artist debuted at number one. When she teamed up with Dan Seals of 70s pop powerhouse England Dan and John Ford Coley, Marie was back at the top of the charts.
Can take you somewhere you've never been.
I just want to turn the wheel west and head towards Montana, you know.
I got to stand right next to her in the vocal booth there, and we actually did it live. It was beautiful.
Coming up, a number one duet that caused quite a stir.
There are some churches or radio stations that banned it.
We had a lot of preachers that wrote us letters.
And when you're recording a duet, is it possible to have too good a time?
Get drunk and sing them old gospel songs and, you know, get drunker and pray for forgiveness.
But first, Matt Schaefer had a number one country duet in 2004. What is his better known stage name? Is it Kid Rock, Jimmy Buffett, Uncle Cracker, or Jack White? Find out the answer when CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns.
Log on to CMT.com for more of CMT's 100 Greatest Duets. Flip through photos, see artist interviews, and get the latest info and TV listings only at CMT.com. Game presents CMT On Tour, Brad Paisley, Time Well Wasted 2005. Featuring Sarah Evans and
and special guest, Sugarland. Go to CMT.com for more info on tickets and tour dates. CMT On Tour, Brad Paisley, Time Well Wasted. Well, what are you waiting for? Presented by Game. Brought to you by Comfort Inn.
Tired of cleaning your dishes after cleaning your dishes? Get a better dishwashing pack. Only Cascade 2-in-1 Action Packs combine the scrubbing power of Cascade with the grease-fighting power of Dawn. Cascade 2-in-1 Action Packs. Now that's clean.
Ellen DeGeneres isn't just hosting the Emmys. She's making a fashion statement.
None of these are sexy enough. Find out what Eva Longoria is wearing. Something lower.
The Emmy Awards, live, with more stars, more surprises, and the only place you can see Donald Trump, William Shatner, Megan Mullally, and CSI's Gary Durden sing live. And you get to vote who's best. Celebrate TV's finest one night before the new season begins. The Emmy Awards, live, CBS Tonight.
The new Steak Fanatic Pizza.
Man, fuel. Cool.
Hey, there's only 23 figurines left! They're statues!
They're statues.
Domino's new Steak Fanatic Pizza. Buy a medium for $9.99 and heap on more Angus steak for just $2. Get the door. It's Domino's.
Are you listening to your heart? You should. Heart disease is the number one killer of women. Do something good for your heart. Smart Start Healthy Heart. The only national cold cereal with ingredients that may help lower both blood pressure and cholesterol as part of a healthy lifestyle. For a healthy heart, start here.
There's only one way to get hair color like this. Garnier Nutrice. Rich, luscious, nourishing color. Because only Nutrice nourishes with grapeseed and avocado oils. Garnier Nutrice. Nourished hair, better color. Garnier.
Whatever the season, when a storm gathers, so do we. The State Farm Catastrophe Team. A full-time force of 2,500 people whose only mission is to be there in times of crisis. Working with local State Farm agents to bring help and hope to more people than any other company. And we'll be there for you, too.
This is the most powerful production ATV made. What do you think?
Hey, listen, I'm thinking about
the Outlander 800, 28% more powerful than the Polaris 800, and 25% more than the Kawasaki Brute Force 750. Now with up to 6 times the warranty of the competition, a full 3 years.
Introducing Almay Intense Eye Color. Shadow, liner, and mascara in expertly coordinated shades for your eye color. It's the color of your eyes intensified. Only from Almay.
Matt Schaefer had a number one country duet in 2004. What is his better known stage name? The answer is Uncle Cracker. The Detroit-born rap DJ duetted with his buddy Kenny Chesney on the number one hit, When the Sun Goes Down.
Long let go my hand.
To kick off his much-anticipated Sevens album in 1997, Garth Brooks released a duet written by and co-starring his old friend Steve Ward.
These guys were friends. They were buddies.
These two guys are best buddies, and you can tell. You can hear it. You can feel it.
We've been friends since way before it all began for him. It's a good relationship. You know, we're good buddies. Garth Brooks is a great country singer. He's a phenomenal entertainer.
It's great to see the writer get up there and do it, too.
Cool thing to be able to entertain and perform with people that you enjoy being around. So you know those guys had to love it.
offense that I do best in a bus, the back of a bus between Milan and Madrid, Spain. When I got back to the States, I called Travis Tritt and I said, I think I got us another song.
Party Boys and good friends Marty Stewart and Travis Tritt won a 1997 Grammy for this rockin' celebration of the honky-tonk life.
Just sing him old gospel songs and, you know, get drunker and pray for forgiveness. And that's just how I see Marty and Travis Tritt. You know, they're just, you know, buddies up on the old mountain road.
We just had a great time. There was an energy on stage, a chemistry on stage that worked.
You know, it's all for the good of the end result of the show. It's about winding up at the goal line at the other end of the show with a ball in your hand going, we did all right.
By 1976, Jim Ed Brown had been an established star for more than two decades when his producer suggested he team up with a young, unknown Helen Cornelius for a duet.
Helen came to town. We met in the studio.
We had never rehearsed together. We had never sung together.
It was fun because the song was so great and the blend was very good. We recognized that immediately.
We recorded it June 1st, and September 1st, it was the number one song in the nation.
Just because.
The song may have been an immediate hit, but its suggestive title concerned many.
There are some churches or radio stations that banned it.
We had a lot of preachers that wrote us letters in the beginning.
If they had just listened to the words, it was, let's do it God's way, let's wait.
The temptation is strong, but it's us so wrong. Please stop and take me home.
It was just a monster hit. For which I'm very thankful.
I want our love to be free, the way God would love to be.
I get the feeling that I don't belong.
Elvis Costello was best known as the angry young man of the punk revolution when he astonished many by recording a stone country song with George Jones. Even more surprising was that Elvis had actually written the 1979 duet, Stranger in the House.
I wrote this song when I was 22. It was obviously written at a time when I've been listening to a lot of George Jones, and I tried to absorb the lessons of the songs that he had sang.
Comes over here from Britain, you know, writes a great country song and gets the greatest country singer of all time to come sing on it.
You'd be surprised at the rock and roll people that love traditional country music. And he wanted to come in and do one with George, and I said, "Mick, come right on."
Perfect to have a duet with George Jones on your repertoire.
Coming up in the next hour, what are you going to do with a cowboy anyway?
You can love a cowboy and have fun with a cowboy.
I fell in love with a cowboy once.
For God's sakes, don't let him stay.
And later, two giant voices.
When they sung, God, it just was like two hammerheads hitting.
When CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns.
The following is a CMT original.
We have had many requests to do a show of all duets.
a chemistry on stage that worked.
Perfect duet.
Louisiana woman.
Mississippi man.
They brought that sizzle to the table.
It was like great sex.
This song killed me.
Killed me.
Y'all rock.
She was giving him the business.
Two of the greatest voices in country music.
They were my favorites.
Put country music duets on the chart.
Favorite duet of all time.
Doesn't get any cooler than that.
They just connected on this crazy level.
That's what makes a great duet.
To CMD 100 Greatest Duets. Here's a recap of numbers 100 to 72. Brooks had become the most successful artist in country music history when he teamed up with Cowboys singer and former world champion bronc rider Chris Ledoux.
What you gonna do with a cowboy?
That particular song was Garth having a chance to do a song with his hero.
Capitol said, well, this would be a great duet. Well, you and Garth do that. I said, well, you ask him. I don't want to put him on the spot.
Garth self-admitted that he stole his entire show, everything he is, from Chris and worshiped Chris as well.
If you ever saw Chris doing a concert, you wouldn't call him anything but a superstar.
When he don't saddle up and ride away.
Yeah. When you go to the bars, you go to the clubs, you go anywhere, and that song was played automatically, packed the dance floor.
You see, it takes a special kind of woman. Put up with the life of cowboy leads.
Maybe kind of a warning to women what they might be in for if they decide this cowboy looks appealing to them.
And you can love a cowboy and have fun with a cowboy, but for God's sakes, don't let him stay.
Cowboys. No, I love cowboys. I fell in love with a cowboy once.
When he don't saddle up and ride away.
Next.
Yeah, what you gonna do with that cowboy? When he don't saddle up and ride away.
Like a candle burning bright.
I always followed Anne Murray's career. Just one of these velvety voices that you just love to listen to.
In 1984, multiple Grammy winner Anne Murray was at the pinnacle of her career. When it came time to record a duet for her Heart Over Mind album, Anne's label suggested Paul McCartney or Elton John. Anne went the exact opposite direction and picked singer-songwriter Dave Loggins. Anne was proven right when Nobody Loves Me Like You Do went to number one and won the CMA's Vocal Duo of the Year in 1985.
When they first came out on the CMA award show, I was sitting there, and I remember when they tore into that song, we were all so thrilled.
Nobody loves me. Nobody loves me like you.
That is a perfect example of when the artist is right. You need to listen.
Nobody loves me. Like you do.
When George Jones began work on his record of duets in 1995, he teamed up with another country superstar, Alan Jackson, to rework a hit he'd made famous in 1971.
I can hardly
bear the side of lipstick on cigarettes there in the ashtray.
Alan Jackson and George Jones singing together, I mean, two of the greatest voices in country music.
I know how much George respects Alan singing, and I know how much Alan loves George Jones singing.
It was his favorite song of mine, and that's the one he wanted to do on the album.
And a lip print on a half-filled cup of coffee that
a lip print on a half-filled cup of coffee that you poured and didn't drink, but at least you thought you wanted it, and that's so much more than I can say for me.
It would just absolutely break your heart.
I can't even bear to look at the lipstick stain on the side of the glass. Because you're gone, you know, but it's a good year for the roses.
But what a good year for the roses.
I've never heard Alan sing better, and I think it's one of those situations where you're standing in the same room as George Jones, and you reach down deep and grab everything you've got and put it into that.
I thought the record came off real good, and I thank Alan for his work.
CMT Crossroads moment.
5 years ago, I didn't think I'd be sitting on a private airplane heading to Nashville to sing Family Tradition with Hank Jr.
Sing as good as this guy one day and play as good as him, and I'm trying, and I got the best teacher out there.
One of Merle Haggard's most poetic compositions is a painfully honest lament he wrote while he went through a devastating divorce.
You need to know my life's gone to hell.
He turned to Janie Fricke to help bring his words to life.
Merle called me and just said, come on in the studio. I've got a song I want to try to your harmony part on.
Janie was an artist, you know, always had been, and the things she did, it was more than just harmony. It was an input.
Looking for ways to fall apart. Looking for a place I can leave my heart.
I'm enhanced by his vocal. I love his true, strong, hard delivery and the purity of his voice.
Looking for a place to fall apart.
It's one of my favorite songs.
In early 1998, country newcomer Anita Cochran reached the top of the charts with her self-penned duet with Steve Wariner, What If I Said.
When I was writing it, I could hear Steve singing in my head as I was writing the song.
She had a rawness. She had a great cut-through sound to her voice that really just meshed with Steve Wariner on that song.
What if I said?
It's really about two people wanting to be together that they don't know how to tell each other.
I've always wondered from the day that we met.
What if I said? The song was number one for a zillion weeks in a row. I will be indebted to radio and to the fans for the rest of my life because they made my dream come true.
What if I said? There's just one place for me.
In 1976, after the amazing success of George Jones and Tammy Wynette's comeback duet, Golden Ring, their label quickly released the last song the divorced couple had recorded as husband and wife.
Times when we're apart, I can't face my heart.
Well, they recorded the song in 74, and by that time, things were tense between the couple. A lot of fun in that session, I would imagine.
Could you imagine going through a divorce and singing Near You?
They had the
their differences, but they didn't bring it to the recording studio.
Oh, if I hated the person singing with me, when I get into a song, that wouldn't bother me at all. I'd completely forget that. That's a very serious moment of my life. When I start singing a song, I try to live that 3 minutes of the song. And then when we finished, I'd be just the opposite, probably.
Coming up, country and R&B collide.
His words, just give me the best Sam you got. I don't know what that means, but I gave him the best I could.
But first, how many of Merle Haggard's five wives recorded charting duets with him? Is the answer one, two, none, or four? Find out when CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns. CMT's 100 Greatest Duets is brought to you by Olive Garden, Starbucks Frappuccino, and Claritin Allergy Products.
So, where are you going to go from here?
Probably the penne with meat sauce. Fettuccine with Alfredo?
I meant with your leg.
It's Olive Garden's never-ending pasta bowl with great new sauces like mushroom Alfredo and creamy five-cheese marinara. Pick one combination of sauce and pasta, then another. Have all you want, just $7.95. Plus, of course, salad and breadsticks.
I'm in a really good place right now, Dad.
At Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
Yeah, Stuart, I know. I got it.
Oh, here's your mail. This too.
Diane, your dog bit the neighbor again.
Frank's freaking out about something.
Diane, this color coding system has color, but it has no code.
If an account can go in either blue or yellow.
Delicious Starbucks Frappuccino coffee drink. It's you time.
I can get so congested from my allergies that I feel like I'm not all there. But I've still got to report the story. So I found Claritin D and got Claritin Clear. That means I'm getting non-drowsy relief and doing my job.
Come on, you're on.
If you want long-lasting relief from your worst congestion, sinus pressure, and itchy eyes without getting drowsy, nothing is stronger or faster than Claritin D. It's the one that works for my allergies and my life. Non-drowsy Claritin D.
Live Claritin Clear.
Tired of cleaning your dishes after cleaning your dishes? Get a better dishwashing pack. Cascade 2-in-1 Action Packs are the only packs combining the scrubbing power of Cascade with the grease-fighting power of Dawn. Because dishes should only be dirty going in the dishwasher, not coming out. Cascade 2-in-1 Action Packs. Now that's clean.
Introducing new Herbal Essences Citrus Lift. New Herbal Essences Citrus Lift.
Introducing Duralast Auto Parts, built to exceed the need.
Built to last, Duralast.
Built with heat-tempered steel and heavy-duty electronics to ramp up under pressure. Duralast Auto Parts, built to exceed the need.
Duralast.
Only at AutoZone.
Where are you going?
A dual action tailgate and an industry first lockable in-bed trunk. The Ridgeline from Honda.
Hey, that looked like my fish.
This is my candle shop. I love scented candles. I have lots around my own house, but with three kids and two dogs, using them isn't always that convenient. That's why I love my Febreze Scent Stories.
Each Febreze Scent Stories disc has a collection of candle-like scents you can use over and over. Push the button, and refreshing scents fill the room fast, and it shuts itself off automatically, so you don't have to. There are lots of scent collections to choose from. Just switch them whenever you want for a completely different scent experience.
Hey, I own a candle shop, and even I gotta admit, you just can't hold a candle to Febreze Scent Stories.
Experience the candle-like scents of Febreze Scent Stories yourself. Go online for a coupon to get Febreze Scent Stories for as low as $14.99. That's a coupon for $10 off the regular retail price. With Febreze Scent Stories, you get candle-like scents without striking a match.
CMT.com gives you new country with the Studio 330 sessions.
Tell it to me, tell it to me.
Raw, rare, real.
That's just a story of my life.
There's a gold in the jukebox.
Authentic and original. Studio 330 sessions. This week on Studio 330 sessions, Joe Diffie takes to honky tonk.
Yeah, the more you drink, the better I look.
Exclusively at CMT.com.
How many of Merle Haggard's five wives recorded charting duets with him? The answer, two. In 1964, Merle and second wife Bonnie reached number 28 with Just Between the Two of Us. And in 1978, he and third wife Leona Williams took The Bull and the Beaver to number 8.
Worlds collided in 1993 for the landmark Rhythm, Country, and Blues album. The project paired the greats from both genres.
You've never heard Rainy Night in Georgia until you've heard these two do it.
Rent by my suitcase, trying to find a warm place to spend the night.
I listened to the song over and over on the play, and I spoke with him, and I said, you know, my thing is, Conway, I don't hear harmony. I can't find a place. And his words, just give me the best Sam you got. I don't know what that means, but I gave him the best I could.
The two of them just weaved in and out on the song, traded lines. And Conway goes low at one point. Does this thing that will just make your hair stand up.
Rainy Night in Georgia was the last song Conway recorded before his untimely death in 1993.
I'll never shall and I never will forget the time that he and I had to do that.
Leon and Willie to me, it made perfect sense because they're both just pretty strange and really talented.
Let them twist it a little bit this way and that way and put all the attitude in the world in it and have number one song.
Leon is another great voice. I mean, I like these guys that don't sound like anybody else.
Been so long on lonely street, they never
After an early career as the ultimate rock sideman, Leon Russell exploded into a superstar and a counterculture icon with his trademark top hat and world-class hair.
When he was playing with Joe Cocker, I mean, my eyes were more on Leon than they were Joe Cocker, you know, because he was just so cool.
I take a little walk down lonely street to
I really got to be on Willie's wavelength to sing with him, and that's a challenge, I'm sure, for any singer, and I admire them all. Because I've sung with Willie, and he just gets a little twinkle in his eye. It's like, you can't catch me.
Willie had opened for Leon in the early 70s and even invited him to co-host his first 4th of July picnic. Willie loves Mavericks, regardless of the labels.
I'm sure he never gives a thought to whether it's going to work or not work. It's just, let's get together and sing.
You'd be so lonely, you could die.
Shenandoah's 1995 hit won both CMA and Grammy Awards. It also helped propel a relatively unknown bluegrass artist by the name of Alison Krauss into the mainstream country limelight.
I really thought what she did
on that tune really, really made that piece of music.
She had started to come out and have these great songs and being nominated for a lot of the award shows.
And that was really kind of a nice thing to watch.
And then you have Marty Raby, who his voice is so very soulful.
His actual tone of his voice and the texture of it is something that, I mean, just draws my attention every time I hear him.
It's just one of those songs that you hear for the first time. You know it's going to be around for a long time to come.
And now, a duet history lesson.
Here he is, Mel Tillis.
In 1970, Mel Tillis got fired from the successful Porter Wagoner TV show starring Porter and Dolly Parton. Smarting from the insult, Mel wanted to get even with Porter.
I was mad. I said, well, I'll just get me a girl singer. And I said, the first one who, girl who walks in the door, I'm going to sing with her. Well, in walks Sherry Bryce. And I said, can you sing? She said, well, a little bit. And I said, come on back here. And we got to singing back there, and I said, let's do an album.
And I want the whole wide world to know you're mine.
Sherry and Mel recorded two albums together, had a top 10 hit, and were nominated twice for CMA Duo of the Year.
The first person that walked through the door is going to be my duet partner. That's a new one on me. I thought I'd heard them all.
Don't let me cross over.
Pearl Butler, Don't Let Me Cross Over, one of those great, great classic country songs.
That's just one of the best duets of all time, and I love Carl and Pearl Butler.
Carl and Pearl were like second parents to me. I just loved them dearly, and I loved their sound.
I know One Step Closer would be heaven divine, but Don't Let Me Cross Over, Love's Cheating Line. It's a hillbilly song.
When they sung, God, it just was like two hammerheads hitting.
Carl just really, he would just sing so hard, but so good. But it was like he had to sing it loud to get it all out of there.
Don't let me cross over, stay out of my way.
Pearl had never sang with Carl professionally until that song came along.
When Pearl got up there and sang with him, it was a perfect thing.
Don't let me cross over.
They're both gone now. We've lost both of them, but they were great.
I think of them a lot of times, you know, in the sweetest way.
Thank you.
I slipped out of the house about sundown while Mama was washing her hair.
Loretta Lynn was still a feisty young upstart when she began a series of duets with the legendary Ernest Tubb. One of their first hits was the fun-filled 1967 honky-tonker, Sweet Thang.
Ernest was singing with Loretta. He'd just sit there and just enjoy her because she is just so enjoyable.
This gentleman that came out there, this tall gentleman, very dry and everything, but it's just Loretta just brought him to life.
I loved the way she sang it. It was just, she was giving him the business.
I loved it. It was sassy.
It just looked like they were having great fun. That's a fun song to sing.
If my sweet thing goes happen by, you'd better take my advice. And if you blink more than twice, you better have something in your eye.
Who can tell just how it starts?
In 1988, Earl Thomas Conley was working on his The Heart of It All album. Emmylou Harris agreed to record a duet for the project. But when it came time to record, Earl Thomas was extremely nervous.
I was worried about singing with her because my voice is so deep. I can sing high, but it's just dirty compared to hers.
He's a great singer, and I love to sing, and it was a great song, so it's almost like, how could it not work?
Boy, her voice was ringing like a bell, clear as a crystal. Boy, she was a good lady to work with. A lot of fun.
I think opposites attract. And you see it in a lot of songs that people have done in this town together. The more different, the better.
And then put Emmy and a great country singer like Earl Thomas Conley on there, and something magic's bound to happen.
Coming up, George Jones does some vocal calisthenics.
George did some stunt singing on that record.
I overdid it.
And Jimmy Buffett finally gets his 24 seconds of fame.
He only sang 24 seconds of a song, and it ends up being his first number one song.
But first, what are the better-known stage names of Leonard Sly and Francis Octavia Smith? Are they Conway and Loretta, Roy and Dale, George and Tammy, or Marty and Travis? Stay tuned for the answer when CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns. Log on to CMT.com for more of CMT's 100 Greatest Duets. Flip through photos, see artist interviews, and get the latest info and TV listings only at CMT.com.
I'm Miranda Lambert. Hurricane Katrina is one of the worst natural disasters in U.S. history. If you can help, please go to CMT.com to find out how. Do what you can with what you have, wherever you are. It all adds up.
So, where are you going to go from here?
Probably the penne with meat sauce. Fettuccine with Alfredo?
I meant with your life.
It's Olive Garden's never-ending pasta bowl with great new sauces like mushroom Alfredo and creamy five-cheese marinara. Pick one combination of sauce and pasta, then another. Have all you want, just $7.95. Plus, of course, salad and breadsticks.
I'm in a really good place right now, Dad.
At Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
It's a revolutionary step in CoverGirl makeup. Outlast makeup with its own primer. Step one, the primer creates a smooth canvas. So two, the color lasts 50% longer. Outlast makeup from Easy Breezy Beautiful CoverGirl.
Whoa, where do you think you're going, Mr. Do-It-All?
I am going to do the laundry right after I start the dishwasher.
Oh, no. I'm about to take a shower.
So,
hello? Nobody likes a cold shower.
Don't worry, I got you covered.
Propane heats water twice as fast as electricity, so your family always has enough hot water.
You know, you and water, not the best of friends.
Propane water heaters can also cost a third less to operate. Learn more at usepropane.com.
Dogs really want what you're eating.
So we made Kibbles and Bits homestyle, with tender, meaty pieces like they were carved right off the bone for that great taste dogs love. And like all leading dog foods, it meets AFCO standards for 100% complete and balanced nutrition.
Kibbles and Bits!
Homestyle. More taste, more joy. And for dogs that love beef, we're taking mealtime to an entirely new level. Introducing new homestyle grilled beef steak and vegetable flavor.
Hair color looking dull? Turn it up to Garnier 100% Color. 100% color equals maximum color, maximum shine. Color pigments grab on, hold on, and it really lasts. Garnier 100% Color. Why settle for less? Garnier.
You gelling?
No telling how much I'm gelling. You gelling?
You know I'm gelling.
Hey, Ellen, you gelling?
I'm gelling. You want some melon?
Nah, but hey, I'm like mud gelling. I'm so gelling.
Are you gelling yet? Dr. Scholl's massaging gel insoles are made from the softest gel ever created. If you and your shoes don't feel outrageously comfortable, you get your money back, guaranteed.
I'm gelling.
You're not gelling.
You're so not gelling.
Are you gelling? Dr. Scholl's.
Baby Ruth is a great tasting candy bar. And when you have peanuts, nougat, and caramel, you don't need bells and whistles. All right, here's one whistle. But no bells. Baby Ruth from Nestle. The real deal.
Score! Yeah.
Guys, what are you doing? Put some cereal over here. Sprinkle the crumbs like this.
Yeah!
Good. Now watch.
For quick carpet cleanups between vacuuming, get the amazing new Swiffer Carpet Fleck.
Cool, huh?
Carpet Fleck actually traps the dirt on a two-sided sticky sheet. So when you're done, the dirt is too.
Awesome.
Well, let me try.
The new Swiffer Carpet Fleck. Just flick, trap, toss.
The new Steak Fanatic pizza.
Man fuel. Cool.
Hey, there's only 23 figurines left! They're statues!
They're statues.
Domino's new Steak Fanatic pizza. Buy a medium for $9.99 and heap on more Angus steak for just $2. Get the door. It's Domino's.
What are the better-known stage names of Leonard Sly and Francis Octavia Smith? None other than the King of the Cowboys and the Queen of the West, Roy Rogers and Dale Evans.
Silence, the passion is burning.
When Patti Loveless decided to record the bluegrass-tinged, out-of-control Raging Fire for her Mountain Soul album in 2001, she invited her old friend Travis Tritt to perform with her.
How can we resist this temptation?
It was just a good song for the both of us to sing on together.
It just seemed like a natural fit, and it really worked.
No two better people to sing it than Patti and Travis, because they both are such heart singers.
That out of control, raging fire. Pain has no memory when you burn with desire.
Two people were together at one time, and now they've seen each other again, and now it's this out-of-control raging fire.
If they stayed around each other long, they would be totally out of control with themselves and be back in trouble again.
That's really good country music.
Yes, we've reached an out-of-control raging fire.
Just a bartender, and I don't like my work.
When George Jones released the title track to his 1978 album, Bartender's Blues, many fans were amazed to find the song was written by and featured an artist not normally associated with country.
This is my favorite George Jones song, in my opinion, and James Taylor wrote it.
All the great singers, no matter what style you did, all knew that George Jones was one of the great soul singers, you know, of all time.
Talk about two great voices. It's just a hell of a combination.
That says a lot about James Taylor, to be able to sing harmony with George Jones. Because George did some stunt singing on that record.
I love that song so much, I really got carried away in the studio. I overdid it.
What are we doing in love?
Dottie West and Kenny Rogers were on a roll in 1981. What Are We Doing in Love was Kenny's 11th number one hit, Dottie's 5th number one, and their 3rd number one as a duo.
She thought it was the prettiest, and I told her I thought it was the sexiest.
It was just something that when it came together, you went, oh yeah, this works great.
So what are we doing in love? What are we doing in a mess like this?
When she sang about heartache, you felt her pain. And when she sang about happiness, you felt her joy.
Just love seeing them perform and just knowing that there's a great friendship there.
My favorite part of What Are We Doing in Love is the story behind that song.
I noticed on the record that it said, What Are We Doing in Love, Dottie West.
He would not put his name plastered all over the record, like a lot of artists insist upon when they are in the height of their career.
It wasn't that I didn't want my name on it. I wanted her to have her glory.
So I like Kenny Rogers even more because of it.
That's what we're doing in love. Some bright morning when this life is over, I'll fly away.
This gospel standard was written in 1929 by part-time singing teacher and full-time cotton picker Albert E. Brumley. It's become the most recorded song in the history of gospel music.
You know, you can't look at country music and not accept gospel music because they came hand in hand.
When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
How many times have you heard I'll Fly Away? 10 million times.
You've never heard it like that one before in your life, though.
Their take on it is a much more relaxed version of the song. Very soft, very subtle.
They sang in their most old-timey way. They both wanted it to sound like a 1930s or 40s record.
They really understand, man. They live, breathe, eat, sleep, drink that kind of music. They love it.
No tricks, no bells and whistles. Just two very plaintive, beautiful voices singing a really, really dear song.
First time you hear that, you're like, oh no, he didn't get Jimmy Buffett, and he did, and it was so awesome.
I've been a Buffett fan forever, and I've been an Alan Jackson fan forever, you know. I said, well, they caught up in the magic here.
You know, I think it turned a whole new generation on to Jimmy Buffett music.
He's every bit our heritage as he is Pop's, in my opinion. And God bless Alan Jackson for bringing him around.
When It's 5 O'Clock Summer went to number one for 8 weeks, Jimmy was especially grateful to his buddy Alan. It was Buffett's first number one song ever.
I always like to thank Alan Jackson for making that phone call to me.
Even though he stated he only sang 24 seconds of a song, and it ends up being his first number one song out of all the great songs that he had. I can't even believe that, but, you know, hey, I'm very proud that his first number one song was on the country chart. Go, Alan.
I'd take 24 seconds of a number one, and anytime Alan needs another duet partner, I can go 25. I can really go that long, Alan. Call me.
Coming up, Dolly and Porter have an old-time camp meeting.
He preached hell so hot that you could feel the heat.
Don't you just see that preacher?
And the possum bares his teeth.
I understand how the business is, you know. If you don't think they can eat your breakfast for you, they can do it in Nashville.
But first, what's the name of Jimmy Buffett's recording studio where he and Alan Jackson recorded their smash duet, It's 5 O'Clock Somewhere? Is it Shrimp Boat Sound Studio? Margaritaville Noise Studio, Buffett's Sound Buffet, or Parrot Headquarters? Find out the answer when CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns.
Thermacare heat wrap for stiff, achy knees. It heated up, and it was all downhill from there, with less knee stiffness, less pain.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, look at my knee move. And the wrap can go anywhere I go, like a heating pad, without the cord. Nice. You know, I used to feel as creaky as my stairs, but look at me now. I'm not being brought to my knees. By my knees.
BK is making NFL history. Now every Angus rapper scores a free day of NFL Sunday ticket from DirecTV.
Chicken of the sea. Low fat, preservative free.
Chicken of the sea.
Hair color looking dull? Turn it up to Garnier 100% Color. 100% color equals maximum color, maximum shine. Color pigments grab on, hold on, and it really lasts. Garnier 100% color. Why settle for less?
Garnier.
What is your cat dreaming about? Same thing every cat dreams about. Great flavor combinations for dry food. Now they can have them. Introducing better than ever Friskies dry foods with multi-flavor combo pieces. Chicken and turkey flavored combos, salmon and chicken flavored combos, and tuna and salmon flavored combos. More flavor in every bite means cats get more out of life. Try better than ever Friskies dry food. Friskies for more.
Keith's Honky Tonk University CD. And Sugarland's Twice the Speed of Life CD at Target.
It's a revolutionary step in CoverGirl makeup. Outlast makeup with its own primer. Step one, the primer creates a smooth canvas. So two, the color lasts 50% longer. Outlast makeup from Easy Breezy Beautiful CoverGirl.
What are you setting your sights on? And when you see it, will you be ready? Just pick up the phone, dial 1-800-645-ARMY, and you'll get this free DVD. You'll learn about the hundreds of opportunities the Army can offer you. Skills, education, healthcare. Call 1-800-645-ARMY, and you'll also get this free boonie hat. Whatever you're looking for, the Army can help you find it.
Bounce makes laundry smell great. But why stop there?
Sunshine, lollipops, and rainbows. Everything that's wonderful is what I feel when we're together. Brighter than I
enjoy the fresh scent of Bounce. All over your house. For more ideas or to share your own, log on to BounceEverywhere.com.
What's the name of Jimmy Buffett's recording studio where he and Alan recorded It's 5 O'Clock Somewhere? The answer is Shrimp Boat Sound Studio, located in sunny Key West, Florida.
In 1970, Dolly Parton and Porter Wagoner were the hottest duo in country music. They capped off the year with a top 10 hit that reflected Dolly's religious upbringing.
Daddy Was an Old Time Preacher Man is very personal to me because that's a song that was written about my grandfather. My Aunt Dorothy Jo and I wrote that. He was a holy roller preacher. I grew up singing in his church, and so one night we were just together and we started singing about Grandpa.
He preached hell so hot that you could feel the heat.
There were some lines in the song that a lot of people got a kick out of, especially the Holy Rollers where I grew up. It's like, he preached hell so hot that you could feel the heat. And Aunt Leona would get up to testify.
I love the way she can tell stories and draw characters. Don't you just see that, Daddy? Don't you just see that, preacher?
Then we'd say, I'm on my way.
Dolly Parton is a songwriter I think probably is the best I had ever heard. She wrote about real things. Real people, real life.
Revivals and camp meetings went for weeks. Folks came from all around to hear you.
Those two voices, they were meant to be together.
It was a great blend. In fact, I've sung with a lot of people through the years, but I don't know that I ever had a better blend with anybody than Porter. That was one of the biggest songs that we ever had.
Your friend.
I'll be your lover
until the end.
Over a decade after Dolly and Porter recorded their last duet, Dolly and Ricky Van Shelton scored a number one hit with Rockin' Years.
Rockin' Years is one of my favorite duets I ever did because it's one of my favorite songs I've ever heard, and not just because my brother Floyd wrote it.
This song is really cleverly written. I mean, it goes through the lifespan of like rocking chairs, rocking babies, rock of by, rock of ages.
He wrote it about my parents, or our parents, and so that made it twice as special, Lord. It was about Mom and Daddy.
Rocking chairs, rocking babies, rock of by, rock of ages.
He was talking about, you know, being with somebody your whole life, and I'll stand by you through our rocking years.
It makes you happy, and it makes you think that love really can last a lifetime.
Van Shelton's one of my favorite singers, and I had really loved a lot of his records.
Ricky had this full, powerful voice, and Dolly's is just as powerful, but it's in a different way.
And I'll stand by you through our rocking years.
He was just a joy to work with and sing with, and it was real easy to work with him, and I loved our blend, and we got along real good.
Now, a duet history lesson. record labels and duets sometimes don't mix. Take, for example, Rockin' Years.
It's funny because the guy that wrote this song wrote it for George Jones to sing with Dolly Parton.
Well, next thing I know, Ricky Van and Dolly Parton's got it playing on the radio.
George did not take the insult sitting down.
I was mad at the time, but I'm not mad anymore because I understand how the business is, you know. So if you don't think they can eat your breakfast for you, they can do it in Nashville if you think about coming here and recording.
Almost 1 year to the day after her husband, Keith Whitley, died of acute alcohol poisoning, Lori Morgan went into the studio and recorded their posthumous duet, Till a Tear Becomes a Rose.
It was a very emotional day for me. It was the day before May 9th, which was Keith's one-year anniversary of his death.
You sit and listen to that and you go,
the story of Lori and Keith and her struggles with him and his struggles with alcohol.
I'm sure that song was very special to her, singing it with Keith already passed away.
Darling, I can see the clouds around you.
That line, darling, I can see the clouds around you, it gives me chills to talk about it, to hear them singing it together.
If you go back and listen to some of those licks and the stuff that they're singing, you don't hear it, you feel it.
Just a great performance by the both of them, and a great song.
Vince Gill took a tour of American roots music with his album, High Lonesome Sound. He touched on country, blues, and New Orleans-style rhythm. For the bluegrass-infused title track, Vince looked to Alison Krauss and her band, Union Station.
The important thing for me is that that song is really her and her band. And it was just as important for me, for Barry and Dan and Ronnie to play on it too, and Jerry.
I had dropped by a soundstage studio, and it just happened to be when Allison was singing that background part, and it was amazing.
You almost can't believe she's like she never raises her voice, and yet her voice could carry across an ocean.
Allison, just she's one of my favorite lady singers. She's just as good as it gets.
That's the beauty of music, is you find somebody you respect and love and admire.
Coming up, Outlaws Kicking Back.
They just kind of didn't care what everybody else thought.
You're just like, woo, yeah.
Reba Kicking In.
Reba totally sells it.
And I was going, wow.
It's very complimentary, I think.
And two old boys kicking up a controversy.
If you're offended, maybe you ought to be.
But first, which of the following singing daughters never made a recording with her father? Was it Lisa Marie Presley, Lori Morgan, Pam Tillis, or Carlene Carter? The answer when CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns. Log on to CMT.com for more of CMT's 100 Greatest Duets. Flip through photos, see artist interviews, and get the latest info and TV listings only at CMT.com.
One act.
One smile.
One meal. One whisper of encouragement.
$1.
One phone call.
One blanket.
One friend.
One child.
One man.
One woman.
It adds up.
CMT
2022, One Country inspires everyday people to take action in their own community. Log on to cmtonecountry.com for more information. Great works are done by hand.
I can't make you want to sit down, but the Angus can. It's so big. Everybody's doing it. It's America's best-selling burger made with 100% Angus beef. The Angus Shroomin' Swiss, the ultimate sit-down burger.
Dell has great deals on PCs waiting for you now. Like this Dimension 2400 desktop. It's yours for $299. Plus, get a free printer. Get more out of now. Dell PCs use Intel Celeron processors.
Well, it wasn't until Hurricane Charlie was over the real danger began.
I'm State Farm Agent Dan Mann, and this is a true story.
I'm a diabetic, and so when the power goes out, that's real bad.
His insulin had to stay cold.
He brought me ice.
Plus a check for emergency living expenses.
Before my neighbor even heard from his insurance company, and with all the thousands of people that needed help down here, I felt like their only one.
When you need someone most, nobody takes care of you like State Farm.
We'd love to prove it to you. Call an agent today.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Nestle Crunch has always been loaded with creamy, crispy chocolate.
Check it, what?
Now, it's loaded with music. Pick up a specially marked Nestle Crunch bar and you could win unlimited Napster downloads for a year. 1,000 rappers are instant winners. Sit down to Nestle Crunch and get ready to download. Nestle Crunch. Why be playing when you can be crunchy?
New 7-Up Plus with calcium. With real fruit juice, 25% of your daily calcium and less than 25 calories per bottle, it tastes so good you can feel it in your bones. 7-Up Plus. For great taste with calcium, the only way to go is up.
Send him out with someone you trust. When he's on the outside, the Guinness of Quakers on the inside. Now with 25% less sugar. Quaker breakfast bars. Another way to get your Quaker a day.
So what do you think?
What's the word I'm looking for?
Desperate?
Let's save that for date three. Okay, but do you love?
I do.
But he doesn't want to date his mother.
So what about something kind of downtown hip-hop?
It's a little more hot than hip.
Well, how about something just kind of earthy?
I think your aura is clashing with your karma. So what do you think?
We love it.
Fed up with forgettable color?
Turn it up to Garnier 100% Color. 100% Color equals maximum color, maximum shine. Here's why.
Pure color pigments grab on, hold on.
So it really lasts.
Pump up your color, max out your shine.
Turn it up to 100%.
Maximum color, maximum shine.
Garnier 100% Color. Why settle for less?
Garnier.
World's fastest
wedding. One lifetime of bliss combo.
Anything else?
Want a side of organ music?
I did.
Usually good and fast don't go together. Until now, new Rice-A-Roni Express. 90 seconds from pouch to plate. It's really good, really fast.
Do those telltale roots make you just want to die? Problem solved. It's Root Touch-Up by Nice and Easy. Our color-matching formula means you lose those roots in just 10 minutes. Root Touch-Up.
Don't be real.
Color wonderful.
Which of the following singing daughters never made a recording with her father? It was Carlene Carter, daughter of Hall of Famer Carl Smith and June Carter Cash. Lori and Lisa Marie both recorded posthumous duets with their fathers, and Pam Tillis recorded her first duet with Mel in 2001.
Well, the only three things in life that make it worth living.
The minute that Al Mulwellen opens up with him strumming that chord, the only two things in life that make it worth living, you're just like, woo! Yeah!
Let's go to Lincoln, Texas.
Willie's Ode to the Simple Things in Life was recorded in 1977 at the height of country music's outlaw era. Like the movement itself, the duet was totally unplanned. Waylon drafted his buddy on the spot.
Things were a lot looser when those guys recorded Luke and Bob, you know, and they were good friends.
I always heard it was just like last minute Willie was around and he was like, hey, you want to just sing this last verse of the song?
I know that Willie just shows up, you know, a lot. I always did. And anytime he did, it made things better.
That's what made that whole outlaw thing
so good. It was like they just kind of didn't care what everybody else thought.
Just an amazing romp. Who couldn't love country music if you've heard that record?
I just loved it. Great melody. Loved the whole idea of it, of there being some kind of nirvana somewhere for them. And it being Blue Rock, Texas. Who knew?
Actually been to Lukenbach, Texas. It is just one intersection with one little building there. Thanks for the hot real estate tip, Waylon and Willie.
You know, Lukenbach is nothing but a little store.
You can't hardly fit a band in there.
It sounds like heaven.
It was a magic time and a magic place.
Almost sounds like this fictional, mythical.
Kind of their own little planet, you know.
To this day, people go to Lukenbach looking for a good time, and they get there, and they're kind of like, where the hell's the party?
Well, it's not what's in Lukenbach, it's just saying I went to Lukenbach. Then you're cool.
Nice, peaceful little town that nobody knew about. And then all of a sudden it became overrun with tourists.
Can I give you a tour of this town? Okay, we're done.
Out in Lukenbach, Texas. But someone killed country music, cut out its heart and soul. They got away with murder.
Murder on Music Row was a scathing indictment aimed at an industry that many thought had turned its back on traditional country music.
It was critical of the industry, and at time it needed some criticism.
Old Hank wouldn't have a chance.
I heard some people were offended by the message of Murder on Music Row, and I always thought, you know what, if you're offended, maybe you ought to be.
Down on Music Row.
Controversy or not, the duet was honored in 2000 as the CMA's Vocal Event of the Year.
Probably those are the only two guys who could ever get away with doing that song.
I think it was just the right song at the right time.
Finally, somebody is standing up for us and telling our story.
Why they even tell the possum to back up and go back home. There's been an awful murder.
Don't kill. Murder's bad.
If You See Him, If You See Her duet was released by both Reba McEntire and Brooks and Dunn. The stunning performance was honed on their highly successful co-headlining tour.
I've toured 4 years with Brooks and Dunn. Ronnie and Kix are just like brothers to me.
We needed some type of an event or something new to keep the pot stirred.
And that song was, If You See Him, was one of the songs we did together to start off the encore.
Reba singing together was, I was going, wow.
To hear these two voices singing, it's very complimentary, I think.
Reba totally sells it. Totally sells it. It's a great, I mean, it's more of a trio than a duet, really, isn't it?
I think Kix was looking for a place to jump in and sing. Did Ronnie ever let him?
Kix is the go-between. Kix is the one that's, we're both asking him, have you seen her? Have you seen him?
I just love Kix on the phone and her saying, just keep this between us. Thanks.
I'll see you later.
That song was like, ching ching, money in the bank.
Coming up in the next hour,
the strangest pairing of all time.
It is definitely a fairy tale love story, but it is a real life love story.
The blackest white guy that you'll ever meet.
So I was probably trying to get a record played for myself.
And everything we see on CMT today and we hear on country radio, you can trace back pretty much to that one record.
That's one of the greatest songs ever recorded.
When CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns.
And now, a CMT original.
We have had many, many requests to do a show of all duets.
A chemistry on stage that worked.
Perfect duet.
Louisiana woman.
Mississippi man.
They brought that sizzle to the table.
It was like great sex.
This song killed me.
Killed me.
Y'all rock.
She was giving him the business.
Two of the greatest voices in country music.
They were my favorites.
Put country music duets on the chart.
Favorite duet of all time.
Doesn't get any cooler than that.
They just connected on this crazy level.
That's what makes a great duet.
CMT 100 Greatest Duets. Here's a recap of number 71 through 48. Brooks and Trisha Yearwood released a fun-filled duet that took a fresh look at the age-old problem of two people trying to hook up.
This guy needs some loving bad. Girlfriend never seems to have any time for him. You can't get through to her.
It's got all the things that you want in the song. It's fun. You can tap with it. You can sing with it. You can have fun with it.
It's a perfect duet song. And I hadn't even thought about that until I heard they were going to do it. And I said, well, hell yeah.
Well, first of all, I mean, what kind of voice does Trisha have? Super.
I thought she did great on it. But then again, she does great on everything. She's got one of those voices that you just hate her for.
It's just a real irresistible song, and I think a song that has an appeal to people who maybe don't consider themselves country fans, because it's that blues influence, and it's a fun song.
They chose a song that had attitude, and I think it was refreshing for all of us watching them. They didn't have to take themselves so seriously, and just to have fun and sing a great song.
I've had nothing but sorrow since you said we were through.
I was running around the house one day and had the music videos going in the background, and I heard this, one of the most beautiful things I've heard in 20 years.
The first time I heard "How's the World Treating You," one, I was stopped in my tracks, but two, I thought, why did we never do this before?
This was one of those where you're sitting there and you ask everyone to be quiet, you know, and you turn it up on the radio.
All my dreams have been shattered. How's the world treating you?
How's the World Treating You has an exceptional pedigree. It was written by Chet Atkins and Bootlow Bryant, and it's been recorded by Elvis Presley and Eddie Arnold. The Louvin Brothers made it a Harmony classic in 1961, but the 2003 combination of Alison Krauss and James Taylor brings the lament of lost love to a whole new level.
You know, it was almost like brother and sister harmony, you know, when they both sang together.
Do you wonder about me?
When they hit hit those notes together, it's almost like hitting a tuning fork or something. You hear this tone that's just so perfect.
It's the sort of thing that makes you want to go find one or the other and, you know, let me in there. Let me be one of those with you.
It's one of the most beautiful things I've heard in years.
How's the world treating you?
And now, a duet history lesson.
Where's the dress?
Mo Bandy and Joe Stampley, Where's the Dress? That was kind of a reference to Boy George.
They said I didn't know who Boy George was. The idea of the song is, if Boy George could make it like that, why couldn't two old country bumpkins?
If it made someone tell me where.
We did it real cheap back then. Even for then, it was cheap.
What was your budget on Where's the Dress? Had to be about $45, $50. Did y'all just pool your money one day?
Cletus, if we had your kind of money that they're spending on your videos now, ours would have probably looked just as good or better. It was really a fun deal. That was a lot of fun.
Mo.
When it
comes to showtime,
we'll be country queens.
On paper, thinking man's cowboy Lyle Lovett and R&B legend the Right Reverend Al Green seem like an odd pairing.
Well, hello there. It's been a long time.
I think one of the reasons, Lyle Lovett's and Reverend Al Green's version of Funny How Time Slips Away is so great is that you wouldn't think those two guys could work together, you know, would fit.
But when the two joined forces on Willie Nelson's Funny How Time Slips Away, they transcended genre and came up with a Grammy-winning celebration of country, R&B, and gospel.
Ain't it funny how time slips away?
When it's done by two people who are so on the same page, it's hard to beat.
Lyle's the blackest white guy that you'll ever meet. I mean, he is so soulful in his music.
And Al Green, I mean, hey, you know.
No one can out-sing Al Green.
Remember what I told you.
And them two sitting there together with their own style singing Funny How Time Slips Away. Willie Nelson was proud.
Sometimes the sum of the parts are much bigger than the song itself.
What they did with that song was just really inspiring.
That's really deep. That's, you know, that's as good as going to church.
To Hear You Say That You Love Me was the 1999 follow-up to Tim and Faith's wildly successful It's Your Love duet. But this one was a little different.
Well, this was a Faith song with Tim backing, as opposed to the previous duet, which was Tim's song with Faith backing.
She sings that song. It's like I can't, every time I hear it, that's the part that I hear, her little part. That it's just beautiful.
If I could taste your kiss, it'd be sweeter. Heaven on the baby.
And it makes even me swoon watching them sing this together. I want to fall in love all over again and run and find my husband and hold hands and snuggle.
It is definitely a fairy tale love story, but it is a real life love story as well. We have a real life.
You know, we have three kids in a relationship, and I have a career, she has a career. There's just this world's constantly just spinning around us.
There's an extra element of they really are in love, so it's a little bit more special.
Coming up,
George Jones rides to the rescue.
I said, what the heck?
George stepped in, the knight in shining armor, and the rest is history.
And a song that showed just how Waylon and Jesse felt for one another.
They always looked right at each other when they sang it, and you totally knew how in love they were.
That was sort of the last love song.
But first, who did actress Ashley Judd record a duet with? Was it with sister Wynonna, with then-boyfriend Michael Bolton, with actor Kevin Kline, or with her mom Naomi? The answer when CMT 100 Greatest Duets continues.
CMT's 100 Greatest Duets is brought to you by Olive Garden and Claritin Allergy Products.
So, where are you gonna go from here?
Probably the penne with meat sauce. Fettuccine with Alfredo?
I meant with your leg.
It's Olive Garden's never-ending pasta bowl with great new sauces like mushroom Alfredo and creamy five cheese marinara. Pick one combination of sauce and pasta, then another. Have all you want, just $7.95. Plus, of course, salad and breadsticks.
I'm in a really good place right now, Dad.
At Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
I can get so congested from my allergies that I feel like I'm not all there. But I've still got to report the story. So I found Claritin D and got Claritin Clear. That means I'm getting non-drowsy relief and doing my job.
Come on, you're on.
If you want long-lasting relief from your worst congestion, sinus pressure, and itchy eyes without getting drowsy, nothing is stronger or faster than Claritin D. It's the one that works for my allergies and my life. Non-drowsy Claritin D.
Live Claritin Clear.
It's a revolutionary step in CoverGirl makeup. Outlast makeup with its own primer. Step one, the primer creates a smooth canvas. So two, the color lasts 50% longer. Outlast makeup from Easy Breezy Beautiful CoverGirl.
It's Lumpy's first Halloween, and the most frightful thing is...
You ate all our candy?
My tummy says it's sorry.
No candy. Now they must save their haunted holiday.
Let's go.
Who's Heffalump Halloween movie? Rated G, now on Disney DVD.
If your car's got a dirty air filter, it's robbing your horsepower and killing your gas mileage. Get to AutoZone and replace your air filter today. Get in the zone. AutoZone.
My single most important accessory? My hair color. Garnier Nutrice Nourishing Color Cream. Rich, luscious, nourishing color. Because nourished hair means better color. And only Nutrice nourishes with grapeseed and avocado oils. So hair takes color better and holds it longer. Root to tip. And grays? Not in here. So frame that face in rich, fabulous color. Garnier Nutrice. Nourished hair, better color. Garnier.
Where did I get this glow? In Bermuda? Or from a wild fling? With a moisturizer.
New Jergens Natural Glow. Moisturize daily to keep your healthy summer glow all year long. Jergens Glowing Skin is in.
New Dawn Direct Foam works in a completely different way. Instead of sweeping grease from dish to dish, it gets rid of it like a vacuum. It absorbs 10 times more grease than ordinary dish liquid. Dawn Direct Foam sucks up so much grease that one pump can clean a whole sink load. New Dawn Direct Foam, a pump of Dawn and grease, is gone.
It's the album that debuted at number one on the country chart. From the top-selling debut country artist of 2005, Miranda Lambert, Kerosene. Featuring her hot new single, Bring Me Down. Miranda Lambert, Kerosene, features 12 songs in all. Including the title track and her debut hit, Me and Charlie Talking. Miranda Lambert, Kerosene. Call or log on now to order Miranda Lambert's Kerosene. Get your copy today.
This is on, Joe. Have a nice day.
in Sugarland.
Love you, baby.
It can only happen on CMT. An all-new Crossroads with Bon Jovi and Sugarland. Tonight at 10, 9 Central. Get more now at CMT.com.
Did Ashley Judd perform a duet with? It was with actor Kevin Kline in the 2004 movie De Lovely. Ashley got in on the family duo tradition with a stellar rendition of the Cole Porter classic In the Still of the Night.
I had your child in Memphis.
In 1967, David Houston was an established star when he released a heart-tugging duet with an up-and-coming female, Tammy Wynette.
David Houston had one of the smoothest, beautiful voices.
To a small farm in Nebraska, to a gold mine in Alaska.
We didn't find.
She sang with the most gut-wrenching, heartfelt pain.
When you get into the story of it, I mean, this is this woman who is following her love. No matter where he goes, she's going to go there.
But this time, only two of us moved on.
That was such a sad song, because they lost their baby and everything. That made me cry.
Now all we have is each other.
The duet became Wynette's first number one hit. But when she and Houston toured together, a rift came between them that ended up creating some magic with another artist on the tour, George Jones.
In a certain concert, David threw a hissy fit, wouldn't sing with Tammy.
So I said, what the heck, I'll do David's part if you want to do the song.
George stepped in, the knight in shining armor, and the rest is history.
In the 1950s and 60s, Roy Orbison became a musical icon. But the 70s were a desolate decade for him. That all changed in 1980 when Orbison teamed up with Emmylou Harris and won a Grammy with That Lovin' You Feelin' Again.
That high, haunting, all it sounds like he was crying, you know, always. It was so emotional.
His voice is one of those extraordinary. It's like a Stradivarius.
When you put Emmy up on top of that, it's really, really an emotional sound.
Despite having sung on hundreds of duets, Emmylou was a bit intimidated by singing with one of her musical idols.
I was really nervous because Roy Orbison goes back to my childhood, really.
She needn't have worried. Emmylou's haunting, liquid vocals were the perfect complement to Orbison's smooth and soaring lead.
She has a beautiful instrument. The tone of Emmylou's voice blends really well with Roy, of course.
You almost feel like he's carrying you up to that note, because you're just following that beautiful voice of his.
And now, Shooter, Waylon, and Lollapalooza.
The first time I ever sang with him was at Lollapalooza.
In 96, and we were... It was crazy because it was Rancid, the punk band, and it was the Four Ramones, Soundgarden, and then Bad, and then Metallica. That was just, like, surreal to a 16-year-old kid, like, or a 17-year-old kid. It was just, like, a surreal experience. Like, other kids are at camp, and I'm doing this summer. You know what I mean? Like, it was like, whoa. So I went out there. There's like 45,000 people, and it was about 102 degrees. It was in New Orleans. I almost f***ed my pants right there, you know what I mean? But he was awful sweet to include me on it. That was really cool, man.
But she was not
gave me.
To me, this song is like a family photo or an historical document.
Well, first there's summer, then I'll let you in September when it comes.
I had already recorded the song by myself, and my husband kept saying, you really need to ask your dad to do this song with you. I said, no, I don't do that. And it suddenly hit me what he was saying. He was saying, look what this song is about. And it's so important that it have both of your voices on it.
You're in her dreams.
So, Dad, I've got this song, you know, September when it comes, I'd love for you to sing on it with me. And he said, well, I'll have to read the lyrics first. I just loved that. It was like, it doesn't matter who you are, honey. It's got to be good.
I cannot move the mountains now. I can no longer run.
I knew that there was something prescient about the song when I wrote it. I knew it, and I couldn't figure out what it was. And I had no idea that it was as specific as the month he would pass away. It's something that I can say when I have grandkids, to say, you know, this was part of who your grandfather was. Here's this picture of the two of us from my past. And it means everything to me.
When this begins,
I'll let you in September. When it comes.
If you had to think about the ultimate masculine voice, I mean, his voice had a beard, you know what I mean? And then you had Jesse, who had that high, lovely, delicate, almost fragile quality. One of my favorite songs, one of my favorite duets.
When Jesse Coulter wrote Storms Never Last, she told husband Waylon about it, then casually tossed it aside. He retrieved it and remarked about the unusual lyrics. Not a single line rhymes, he said. Each line stands alone.
When I first heard the song, it sounds like it rhymes. It didn't need to rhyme. You know, somehow the music pulled it together.
I sang it to him, and he says, ha, this is good.
She has always had a way of being able to write a song and completely pour out her heart on a sheet of paper and hit the point, hit the mark every time.
I pick wildflowers and some soft, sad song.
I used to play that every night on stage, and I'd always watch it. She'd come out, and they'd always look right at each other when they sang it, and you totally knew how in love they were.
It's our signature song. It is. It's a cool song. We love to sing together.
Storms never last.
That is the real deal. That is a couple that has been to hell and back and stuck by each other and loved each other to the very end. And she will always love him. He always loved her. That's pure genius.
Coming up, Dolly goes back to the well one more time.
I thought, well, it's never been a hit for the duet.
When they sing that song, it just takes you into another world.
And a duet that leaves little to the imagination.
Not gonna go to your bedroom.
I don't know what to say.
But first, why did Jim Reeves and Deborah Allen quit recording together after releasing three hit duets? Was it because Deborah's husband became jealous? They argued over money. Deborah entered a convent, or Reeves had been dead for 15 years. Find out the answer when CMT 100 Greatest Duets continues.
Log on to CMT.com for more of CMT's 100 Greatest Duets. Flip through photos, see artist interviews, and get the latest info and TV listings only at CMT.com.
I dropped a quarter, played Golden Rain on the jukebox.
show's over, but Gretchen still wants to play.
If you're waiting on me, you're backing up.
The real music happens backstage. They're the hits you haven't heard yet. Gretchen Wilson, Undressed, Saturday at 9, 8 Central on CMT.
Mom's wrinkles, your daughter's pimples. Your face is caught in between. Stuck in the middle. This one-step moisturizer fights aging and blemishes, as well as leading department store brands. New Olay Total Effects Anti-Aging Anti-Blemish.
Patti Loveless brings you Dreamin' My Dreams, a powerful collection by one of country's purest voices. Featuring the new single, Keep Your Distance. Patti Loveless, Dreamin' My Dreams, available wherever music is sold.
You gellin'?
No telling how much I'm gellin'. You gellin'?
You know I'm gellin'.
Hey, Ellen, you gellin'?
I'm gellin'. You want some melon?
Nah, but hey, I'm like mud gellin'. I'm so gellin'.
Are you gelling yet? Dr. Scholl's massaging gel insoles are made from the softest gel ever created. If you and your shoes don't feel outrageously comfortable, you get your money back. Guaranteed.
I'm gelling.
You're not gelling.
You're so not gelling.
Are you gelling? Dr. Scholl's.
So, where are you going to go from here?
Probably the penne with meat sauce. Fettuccine with Alfredo?
I meant with your leg.
It's Olive Garden's never-ending pasta bowl with great new sauces like mushroom Alfredo and creamy five-cheese marinara. Pick one combination of sauce and pasta, then another. Have all you want, just $7.95. Plus, of course, salad and breadsticks.
I'm in a really good place right now, Dad.
At Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
Fed up with forgettable color?
Turn it up to Garnier 100% Color. 100% Color equals maximum color, maximum shine. Here's why.
Pure color pigments grab on, hold on.
Does it really last?
Pump up your color, max out your shine.
Turn it up to 100%.
Maximum color, maximum shine.
Garnier 100% Color. Why settle for less?
Garnier.
Yeah, Stuart, I know. I got it.
Oh, here's your mail. This too.
Diane, your dog bit the neighbor again.
Frank's freaking out about something.
Diane, this color coding system has color, but it has no code.
If an account can vote in either blue or yellow,
delicious Starbucks Frappuccino coffee drink. It's you time.
Dell has great deals on PCs waiting for you now. Like this Dimension 2400 desktop. It's yours for $299. Plus, get a free printer. Get more out of now. Dell PCs use Intel Celeron processors.
Suture.
Usually good and fast don't go together. Until now, new Rice-A-Roni Express. 90 seconds from pouch to plate. It's really good, really fast.
It's a revolutionary step in CoverGirl makeup. Outlast makeup with its own primer. Step one, the primer creates a smooth canvas. So two, the color lasts 50% longer. Outlast makeup from easy, breezy, beautiful CoverGirl.
Why did Jim Reeves and Deborah Allen quit recording together after releasing three hit duets? The answer is D. In 1980, Jim Reeves had been dead for over 15 years when RCA dubbed Deborah's voice into some of his old tracks, including the top 10 hit, Take Me In Your Arms and Hold Me.
In 1949, Jimmy Wakely and Margaret Whiting were the hottest duo in America.
Seems we always have to slip around to be together, dear. Slipping around.
Afraid. We might be found.
Margaret Whiting was a very good pop singer. She could sing anything.
Jimmy Wakely was always a cowboy singer. He did a tremendous amount of movies.
I know I've made mistakes, dear.
But I'm so in love with you.
The huge success of Slippin' Around, number one for 17 weeks, changed the face of American music forever, especially country music.
Slippin' Around was the first really huge successful cheating song.
Big hit. Big hit.
With today's sexually charged music, Slippin' Around, written by Hall of Fame songwriter Floyd Tillman, may sound tame. But in post-World War II America, the song's surprising success stretched the boundaries of what country could sing about.
Oh, you're tied up with someone else, and I'm all tied up too.
I did have the privilege of knowing Floyd Tillman, and he was pretty well going to do what he was going
to
do.
Hope someday I'll find a way to bring you back to me.
They clicked together in the studio. They just made beautiful music together, sang Slippin' Around, and it sold a million records in 1949.
And I won't have to slip around to have your company. If I need you, will you come?
Two of the most admired voices in country music came together in 1981. When crooner Don Williams asked Emmylou Harris to record with him, one of their duets was If I Needed You.
Everything they do is so understated and so touching.
I would swim to see for the leaves you'd play.
Emmylou to me is in the pantheon of saints.
First got into country music.
Yeah, Don Williams is my all-time favorite singer.
Don Williams is, you know, of course, the gentle giant. If you're not a Don Williams fan, you need to go to the doctor. I think it's a perfect pairing. And of course, doing a song written by the late, great Towns Van Zandt, you know, seals the deal.
Just think of the combination. You take a Towns Van Zandt song, you put Don Williams and Emmylou Harris on it, and that's magic.
Now, a great CMT Crossroads moment.
I'm crazy thinking that my love could hold you.
Part of the joy of collaborating is getting on stage, even interpreting somebody else's music, but just playing.
I'm crazy for trying, crazy.
It's like a good old-fashioned schooling, or actually a very good old-fashioned ass-kicking.
Already achieved unbelievable success with her song I Will Always Love You when she teamed up with Vince Gill in a duet of the ballad in 1995.
I thought, well, it's never been a hit with a duet, and I love singing with Vince, and he was hot at the time, and I'm always trying to work with somebody hot at the time. So I was probably trying to get a record played for myself. So I asked Vince if he'd sing it, and he just came right over, and it was a beautiful record, and he made it.
He and Dolly together on it, when they sing that song, it just takes you into another world.
To watch the Porter Wagoner show every weekend, and he was a huge Dolly Parton fan, so he was the first person I called when I told him Dolly called and wanted to do a duet.
And his dad said, I'll be right down, and he came and went to the session and had his picture made with Dolly, and I think that was probably the sweetest thing about the whole day.
I wish you joy.
Wish you joy.
And
songs together, Vince Gill and Dolly Parton. I was very proud of the song, and I was proud of him for making it sound so good.
You get the opportunity to work with people that are that gifted, that talented, you just, you don't screw that up.
That's that kind of thing where you just can't help but watch.
Well, that's so personal. We love all and all, but not gonna go to your bedroom.
I mean, it kind of says, I don't know what to say.
Faith and Tim's 2000 Grammy winner was their third romantic duet. It followed It's Your Love and Just to Hear You Say That You Love Me and solidified their position as country's most passionate couple.
Do you know what you do to me? Everything inside of me.
It's magic. They're magic together. That's what people respond to.
Tim and Faith are like the Camelot of country music. They really are. I mean, they are the fairy tale.
And when you see a couple like that, that just worship each other, adore each other, and have beautiful children, and they can express it in their music and share it with each other and share it with the world, you just want so much for them to always have that.
Captured what we were trying to do. I think it really captured the mood of the song.
It was very romantic. As romantic as the video portrays it to be, it was even 10 times more than that.
Coming up, a match made in heaven.
I wrote that song with her in mind.
Such an emotional song.
Finally, we got to do one together.
And later, a modern-day classic.
Wouldn't it be cool if we could get talk Willie Nelson into singing this second verse?
What a cool thing to get to do a duo with one of your idols.
But first, which of the following artists has not recorded a duet with Willie Nelson? Is it Little Jimmy Dickens, Aerosmith's Steven Tyler, Jessica Simpson, or Bonnie Raitt? Find out the answer when CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns.
Hi, I'm Reba McEntire. Hurricane Katrina is the worst natural disaster in U.S. history. You can help with the relief effort. Why don't you go on to CMT.com and find out how? Do what you can with what you have, wherever you are, because it all adds up.
It's a revolutionary step in CoverGirl makeup. Outlast makeup with its own primer. Step one, the primer creates a smooth canvas. So two, the color lasts 50% longer. Outlast makeup from easy, breezy, beautiful CoverGirl.
Why take your family to a casual dining restaurant and pay $8 a person when you can get the same quality meal for half the price at KFC? Get 10 pieces of Kentucky Fried Chicken, two large home-style sides, and four biscuits for less than $4 a person. Your dollar goes further at KFC.
Help Gary Hall Jr. and Barbasol beat juvenile diabetes.
Close shave, Gary.
I'm sorry.
Cans with my photos help kids. Better buy a Barbasol.
Salmon spend most of their adult lives in the ocean. After maturing, they migrate back to spawn in the same rivers and streams where they were born. It is here that many a salmon's life is cut short. However, there is good news. I just saved a bunch of money on my car insurance by switching to Geico.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Introducing Duralast auto parts built to exceed the need.
Built to last, Duralast.
Built with heat-tempered steel and heavy-duty electronics to live up under pressure. Duralast auto parts built to exceed the need.
Built to last, Duralast.
Only at AutoZone.
We hit the boat.
We hit the boat.
It was the perfect vacation.
Right up.
30th.
I think it's a map.
Uncover the secret. Unlock the mystery. Into the blue. Rated PG-13.
There's only one way to get hair color like this. Garnier Nutrice. Rich, luscious, nourishing color. Because only Nutrice nourishes with grapeseed and avocado oils. Garnier Nutrice. Nourished hair, better color. Garnier.
America has spoken. Lemon Ice is the new flavor of Crest Whitening Expressions toothpaste. Molly Rosen reports.
Bob, it's a very emotional scene here. Lemon Ice!
Crest Whitening Expressions Lemon Ice, coming soon.
Now there's a new way to get rid of grease. Introducing Dawn Direct Foam. Dawn Direct Foam actually sucks up and absorbs grease like a vacuum. Instead of sweeping it from one dish to the next, it absorbs 10 times more grease than ordinary dish liquid, so your sponge doesn't spread the grease to other dishes. And you just need a little. Next to ordinary dish liquid, it sucks up so much grease that one pump can clean this whole sink load of dishes. And each bottle contains 250 pumps. That's 250 sink loads from one bottle. So stop sweeping grease from dish to dish and get rid of it altogether. Available in 3 cents in money-saving refills. New Dawn Direct Foam. A pump of Dawn and grease is gone. Go online for a money-saving coupon.
Which of the following artists has not recorded a duet with Willie Nelson? Believe it or not, the answer is Willie's longtime buddy, Little Jimmy Dickens.
I want to do a duet with Willie Nelson. Willie?
I dedicate this song to all the girls I've loved before. To the girls I once loved.
The strangest pairing of all time with a country god and a Latin lover.
Julio, what are you doing? Willie, what are you doing? Together? Wow.
I love to hear that song. I mean, Julio's got a great voice. He's a playboy. He's always got the tan. He's always in the tux. Then you got Willie over here who hasn't had a bath in like 3 weeks. He's got the bandana on. And they're singing about all the girls they've loved before. That's pretty cool.
In 1983, Willie Nelson and his wife Connie were in London when they heard international singing star Julio Iglesias on the radio.
Julio Iglesias, at the time, had probably already sold 120 million records worldwide. But he'd sold zero in America.
When Willie remarked he liked Julio's voice, Connie suggested a duet. Within months, the unlikely pair hit number one.
All the girls we've loved before.
Opened in and out my door.
Oh, I love Julio Iglesias.
It's genuine. It's sincere. And I think only they could actually sing to all the girls I've loved before and it not seem audacious and like a braggart.
To all the girls I've loved before, blood test. Okay? Check it out, just to be sure.
When Patti Loveless first heard her heart-wrenching 1997 hit, You Don't Seem to Miss Me, she knew there was only one artist she was destined to sing it with.
It was a George Jones song. It had George all over it. So it was meant to be.
Yeah, it was a great song, and she is a great traditional country singer, and that's what I love.
Patti Loveless, who has one of the most amazing
mountain voices.
You know when these two voices are meant to be together, and that's what makes a great duet.
You put two people like that together that sing traditional country music, and we can work easy together.
Listen to the harmony of George and how good they sound together. Now, who's blending with who? Who knows? Who cares? All I know is this. The two sound absolutely amazing together.
I don't need to say anything about George Jones. We all know he is the man.
I was so proud. That's the record that I'm very, very proud of and very honored that, you know, to have someone, one of my heroes, George Jones, sing with me on.
A duet history lesson.
Let me play up there with those stars.
There was a time when Frank Sinatra was doing a duet album with country music artists. Well, when I got asked if I wanted to do it, I said, sure, I'd love to. And Phil Ramone came to Nashville, and he had Frank's version already cut. So all I had to do was do my part and then do some harmonies with Frank. I thought our duet was a great version of Fly Me to the Moon. I was very happy with it. I thought it sounded great, and I still like it. But for whatever reason, he decided not to use it on the album, and that really made me mad. But I got over it.
First time I heard Picture on the radio, I thought, well, what is this? I mean, it's sonically, everything, it sounded so different from anything on country radio.
I think, too, if I'm not mistaken, that's the first song with two acts from outside the country genre come together and did a song for the country format.
It worked. It just worked. And there wasn't, in the beginning, a little resistance, and then...
You don't.
Vince Gill and Patti Loveless have recorded with each other as far back as 1988, when Vince sang backup on Patti's first number one single. A year later, Patti returned the favor on Vince's first number one. In 1999, the pair joined forces for a real duet.
You're my kind of woman,
and you're my kind of man.
Oh, living.
You know how rare it is, I think, that songs are written as duets. I think that doesn't happen very often, and I wrote that song with her in mind.
And he asked me to come in and sing My Kind of Woman, My Kind of Man, and I said I'd love to, and that's what happened.
My body trembles with the touch of your hand.
It was tailor-made for her, you know?
Patti just rips my heart out every time she sings a song. Vince has an amazing vocal.
Such an emotional song, and their voices are just a great gathering.
You're my kind of woman. You're my kind of man.
We both have always envisioned the kind of partnership that Conway and Loretta had, that George and Tammy had.
It was like the old, you know, Porter Wagoner, Dolly Parton, and Loretta, and Conway Twitty, and it was a true duet. So, finally, we got to do one together. I hope we get to do many more.
Coming up, keeping the outlaw tradition alive.
Willie's done it all, seen it all.
And to hear a new song from Willie was great.
But first, for what couple did singer-songwriter Stevie Nicks originally write the hit duet Leather and Lace? Was it Rodney and Roseanne, Waylon and Jesse, Porter and Dolly, or Keith and Lori? The answer when CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns.
Log on to CMT.com for more of CMT's 100 Greatest Duets. Flip through photos, see artist interviews, and get the latest info and TV listings only at CMT.com. She has been called the most complete and gifted female singer of her generation. Now, CMT brings you two decades of hits and new songs in an exclusive, intimate performance. CMT presents Winona, Her Story.
It's live, baby.
Winona, Her Story, premieres Friday at 9, 8 Central, only on CMT.
It's a revolutionary step in CoverGirl makeup. Outlast makeup with its own primer. Step one, the primer creates a smooth canvas. So two, the color lasts 50% longer. Outlast makeup from easy, breezy, beautiful CoverGirl.
Yeah, Stuart, I know. I got it.
Oh, here's your mail. This too.
Diane, your dog bit the neighbor again.
Frank's freaking out about something.
Diane, this color coding system has color, but it has no code.
You're gonna count the code
either blue or yellow.
Delicious Starbucks Frappuccino coffee drink. It's you time.
On this job, you notice things. Like this new Steak Fanatic pizza. It's a big hit with the guys.
Steak Fanatic pizza.
Mm-hmm.
Man fuel. Cool.
Hey, hurry up! Only 23 figurines left, Hank! They're statues!
They're statues.
Introducing Domino's new Steak Fanatic pizza. Angus steak piled on even more steak, smothered in cheese. Buy a medium for just $9.99 and heap on even more Angus steak for just $2. At the door, it's Domino's new Steak Fanatic pizza.
Pick up a specially marked Nestle Crunch Bar, and you could win unlimited Napster downloads for a year. 1,000 rappers are instant winners. Nestle Crunch. Why be plain when you can be crunchy?
Brooks and Dunn Hillbilly Deluxe CD at Target.
Hey, it's Bob. Looks like things are still going well for Bob. Yes, it looks like Bob is continuing to enjoy the lift he gets from Enzyte, a natural male enhancement. Now you can join Bob and the over 3 million men who trust and enjoy the benefits of natural male enhancement. Just call or go online to enjoy big savings and get 3 months of Enzyte for free. That's right. For a limited time, you can enjoy big savings and get 3 months for free. Yes, a full 6 month cycle of Enzyte and natural male enhancement for just $99. So, if you've ever been curious about natural male enhancement, there's never been a better time to try Enzyte and find out for yourself what keeps Bob smiling. Yes, with Enzyte, it looks like personality and good looks aren't the only thing people are noticing about Bob. If you're not ready for a prescription, call now and get 6 months worth of huge savings, free shipping, and a free t-shirt of smiling Bob. With an offer this big, it's enough to throw a parade. Enzyte, the once daily tablet for natural male enhancement.
The more we get together, the more we get together, the happier we'll be. Cause your friends are my friends, and my friends are your friends. The more we get together, the happier we'll be. There's Michael and Jimbo and that one guy you know. The more we get together, the happier we'll be.
What couple did singer-songwriter Stevie Nicks originally write the hit duet Leather and Lace? It was for Waylon and Jesse. Waylon gave the title to Stevie and asked her to write a song for him and Jesse. However, she ended up recording it herself with her then-beau, Don Henley. Since Waylon's death, Stevie has begun to dedicate the song to him in her concerts.
We'll raise up our glasses against evil forces, singing whiskey for my man. Beer for my horses.
Me and Scott Emmerich wrote Whiskey for My Man, Beer for My Horses.
After we got done, he said, man, you know who I ought to get to sing the second verse and do a duet on?
I said, man, wouldn't it be cool if we could get talk Willie Nelson into singing the second verse. And Scott Emmerich is like, you know, Willie is the only thing that's ever come along to Scott Emmerich.
He's my hero and Toby's hero also.
Well, I'm at the Palm here in Nashville one night and look up, and Willie jumps up, comes over and says, hey, how's it going?
Toby said, hey, Willie, I got a song for you. I want you to do a duet. Willie said, well, send me a copy of it. Let me hear it.
He said, what's the name of it? I said, Whiskey for My Men, Beer for My Horses. He goes, I don't even need to hear that. I'll do it. Whiskey for my men.
Cool thing to get to do a duo with one of your idols, you know, somebody that you've grown up listening to and you love. That's awesome.
The collaboration between Guru and Disciple spent 6 weeks at number one. It marked Willie's return to the top spot after an absence of 14 years.
To hear him on radio again and to hear a new song from Willie was great.
Willie's done it all, seen it all.
Well, everybody wants to do duets with Willie.
Yeah.
He's an American icon. He's a treasure.
Graham Parsons and Emmylou Harris's Hickory Wind is regarded as one of the most significant songs in contemporary music history.
Hickory Wind, I think, represents a real sort of crossroads.
Everything we see on CMT today and we hear on country radio, you can trace back pretty much to that one record.
Parsons turned an entire generation on to his innovative blend of country and rock.
Which is where the Eagles came from and the Byrds and Linda Ronstadt. And Graham Parsons and Emmylou sort of created California's country rock.
Fell in love with country music through the recordings of Graham Parsons and the various bands he was in, the Burritos, the Byrds, but especially his solo recordings with Emmylou Harris.
He gave the world arguably the greatest female country singer ever, and a woman who defines the dignity and grace of country music unlike anyone else.
Hickory Wind appeared on Graham's final album, Grievous Angel. He died of a drug overdose in 1973 at the age of 26. This plaintive duet of loneliness was a fitting tribute to the legacy of Graham Parsons.
I think there's always something that we're searching for. That's why songs about loneliness and searching for that missing person or that missing piece of ourselves, that's why they resonate for us. Certainly Graham understood that better than and articulated it maybe better than a lot of people.
Coming up in the next hour.
Next thing I know, she's done it with Vince Gill. Wait, what happened to me and you, Reba?
It was the song that took both of our careers to another level.
She would talk to me about it. Like, she can't believe me here at this age doing this.
When CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns.
We have had many, many requests to do a show of all duets.
A chemistry on stage that worked.
Perfect duet.
Louisiana woman.
They brought that sizzle to the table.
It was like great sex.
This song killed me.
Killed me.
Y'all rock.
She was giving him the business.
Two of the greatest voices in country music.
They were my favorites.
Put country music duets on the chart.
Favorite duet of all time.
Doesn't get any cooler than that.
They just connected on this crazy level.
That's what makes a great duet.
Welcome back to CMT 100 Greatest Duets. Here's a recap of numbers 47 to 30.
Yeah.
if I were a carpenter.
When Johnny and June released this duet in 1969, Cash was arguably the biggest superstar in the world, making the eloquent lyrics all the more meaningful.
If I worked my hands in wood, would you still love me?
I'd answer you, yes I would.
And would you not be above me?
So sweet. And it also did give it an extra dimension that was so far from what he had become.
Johnny and June just made that record perfect. The song is so unique, and I got a feeling when I heard them singing to each other, it was real.
I were a miller.
They made it into a conversation, you know, and it was so perfect for the two of them and their love for each other, because you knew that, I mean, man, she would have lived in a tent with that guy.
Adam Hill will grind in an arms, my colored blouse, on the soft shoes shining.
That was a beautiful song, and they did such a good job with it. They were so original.
Would you marry me anyway? Would you have my baby?
Within months of its release, two joyous events followed. The duet won a Grammy, and the marriage was blessed with a baby boy, John Carter Cash.
I'd have your baby.
Goes to number one, she has the baby. I mean, life doesn't usually work like that.
The chemistry between John and June on that particular song was just kind of indescribable and magic. It has a charisma that you can't quite hold or put your hands on that's timeless.
In 2004, a legend hooked up with a hipster and had the critics raving. But in Nashville, Loretta Lynn and White Stripes rocker Jack White had folks scratching their heads.
I was kind of skeptical in the beginning when I heard Jack White was doing a record on Loretta Lynn. I was like, what's going to happen here?
She would talk to me about it. She can't believe me here at this age doing this.
Loretta actually said, do you know who Jack White is? And I said, well, I know that he's the guy in the White Stripes. And she said, well, he loves me.
I can understand him totally being enamored with her, falling in love with her, as we all have, and enjoying the work with her. She's a hoot.
Let's say we knew last night, got drunk, but we loved enough for the both of us.
Oregon, an autobiographical tune about Loretta's rough and tumble early days with husband Doolittle, turned into a smash duet. It not only won Loretta her first Grammy in 33 years, but it won over the doubters as well.
Once I got past the shock factor, as everybody did, I started really digging it.
I just loved Portland, Oregon. I thought, golly, I wish I could have cut that.
That record, man. I love Jack White. I think he's great. I think what he did with her was perfect. I'm proud that Jack White had enough vision and radar to figure that one out. Good for everybody. I always knew she was a rock star. It was just a matter of time.
And now, Brad Paisley explains the meaning of his favorite duet.
Down the chimney came Wilbur.
For me, it's Shotgun Red and Ralph Emery.
He was stirring all around the house.
It's dealing with a very delicate topic, and that's the topic of a moose. Most people don't realize that the moose is absolutely symbol for heartache. And Christmas moose is dealing with the heartache around Christmas time of being lonely. I keep trying to top this Christmas moose thing with duets and with the local events and things that I do. What's the full title of it? It's Mouse? It's Christmas Mouse? Oh, man, I thought it was Christmas Moose. That changes everything.
This record makes my toes curl.
And of course blew me away, and I think probably everybody away.
This song killed me. Killed me.
I think it was passionate. I mean, that's the best word I can use to describe it.
The song was typical of the style Orbison wrote for himself. The amazing range heard in his soaring solo rendition in 1961 was considered a modern classic.
Could sing anything and was not restricted to any one genre and had a voice like no other. It was so unique. Nobody since has ever sounded like Roy Orbison.
Roy Orbison, he is a god. I mean, let's forget legendary status. Roy Orbison is a god.
Katie Lang, like many singers, idolized Roy Orbison. When the call came to duet on this Orbison classic, Katie hesitated to accept.
You're stepping onto hallowed ground there.
The more she pondered on it, she thought, what am I, nuts? This is Roy Orbison. I have the chance to have my voice on a record with Roy Orbison. Of course I'm going to do it.
From now on, that'll be the version that I'll always remember.
One of the best duets that's ever been made and ever will be made, probably.
Coming up, a duet that has Leanne Womack feeling on top of the world.
I can remember sitting on that horse, going toward the Capitol, looking over at Willie and just thinking, oh, buddy, I'm the luckiest girl in Texas.
And a combination that's out of this world.
Sort of like Star Wars. You got Obi-Wan and you got Luke. And that's what this is.
But first, why is the title to the instrumental duet Dueling Banjos misleading? Is it because both parts were played by only one person? No banjos were used on the record. The Duelers were a banjo and a guitar, or a computer simulated both parts? Find out the answer when CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns.
CMT's 100 Greatest Duets is brought to you by Olive Garden, Starbucks Frappuccino, and Claritin Allergy Products.
So, where are you going to go from here?
Probably the penne with meat sauce. Fettuccine with Alfredo?
I meant with your leg.
It's Olive Garden's never-ending pasta bowl with great new sauces like mushroom Alfredo and creamy five-cheese marinara. Pick one combination of sauce and pasta, then another. Have all you want, just $7.95. Plus, of course, salad and breadsticks.
I'm in a really good place right now, Dad.
At Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
Yeah, Stuart, I know. I got it.
Oh, here's your mail. This too.
Diane, your dog bit the neighbor again.
Frank's freaking out about something.
Diane, this color coding system has color, but it has no code.
The account can only have either blue or yellow.
Delicious Starbucks Frappuccino coffee drink. It's you time.
I can get so congested from my allergies that I feel like I'm not all there. But I've still got to report the story. So I found Claritin D and got Claritin Clear. That means I'm getting non-drowsy relief and doing my job.
Come on, you're on.
If you want long-lasting relief from your worst congestion, sinus pressure, and itchy eyes without getting drowsy, nothing is stronger or faster than Claritin D. It's the one that works for my allergies and my life. Non-drowsy Claritin D.
Live Claritin Clear.
Now back to Crochet Today.
With your G-hook, keep those stitches loose. And soon, you'll have a nice cover for that little plastic air freshener. See?
Introducing New Glade Glass Scents. The air freshener you don't have to cover up. New Glade Glass Scents natural fragrance oils give you continuous light fragrance for 30 days. And it looks so decorative, you'd never think of covering it up.
Next week, the bunny cover.
New Glade Glass Scents. The air freshener you don't have to cover up. S.C. Johnson, the family company.
From portable DVD players and flat screen TVs to laptops and digital cameras, when it comes to living the digital lifestyle, bring it home at the Walmart price.
I had a really good time tonight.
Me too.
Smell great longer, stay out later with new Red Zone After Hours Body Spray.
Have a nice day, ladies. Good morning, Mr. Fisher. Good morning, Mr. Ryan. Good morning, Miss Keaton. Good night, Mr. Morgan.
Smell great longer, stay out later with new Red Zone After Hours Body Spray.
Now there's a new way to get rid of grease. Introducing Dawn Direct Foam. Dawn Direct Foam actually sucks up and absorbs grease like a vacuum. Instead of sweeping it from one dish to the next, it absorbs 10 times more grease than ordinary dish liquid, so your sponge doesn't spread the grease to other dishes. And you just need a little. Next to ordinary dish liquid, it sucks up so much grease that one pump can clean this whole sink load of dishes. And each bottle contains 250 pumps. That's 250 sink loads from one bottle. So stop sweeping grease from dish to dish and get rid of it altogether. Available in 3 cents and money-saving refills. New Dawn Direct Foam. A pump of Dawn and grease is gone. Go online for a money-saving coupon.
Now, CMT owns the A-list more than ever. Be in the know and at the core of entertainment's latest news with CMT Insight.
Hosted by me, Katie Cook.
From the biggest celebs, rising stars, and cutting-edge music to glamour, trendsetters, and more. Cross the velvet rope with CMT Insider. CMT Insider. Tonight at 11, 10 Central on CMT.
Why is the title to Dueling Banjos misleading? The answer is C. The popular instrumental duet from the 1972 movie Deliverance is actually a duel between a banjo and a guitar.
Song if I ever heard one in my life. And there's two honky-tonkers doing it, too.
In the 60s, Buck Owens records had influenced a whole generation, including the Beatles and the Rolling Stones. But when his vocal partner Don Rich passed away, Buck's sound was never the same.
And when Don Rich died, part of Buck Owens died, too.
We all forgot about Buck Owens. You know, he was gone. He was out of the picture.
Dwight was just starting to race up those charts. He was just getting into his own, and everyone compared him to Buck.
I think he's one of a handful of those real catalysts for country music that kept it alive.
I was a Dwight Yoakam fan right from the very beginning. I saw him, he reminded me of Neil in a lot of ways.
When the duet hit the top in 1988, it was Dwight's first number one single and Buck's first number one in 17 years. It was also the first time Buck had agreed to sing with anyone since Don Rich's passing.
I've spent 1,000 miles of coming. Yes, I've worn blisters on my heels.
For him to sit down with Dwight and say, all right, you know, this is going to happen. I'll sing with you. It's the ultimate stamp of approval. I love it when an influence and the new guy get together. It's sort of like Star Wars. You got Obi-Wan and you got Luke. And that's what this is.
To this day, you know, a friendship that I'll cherish always.
For Leanne Womack, the offer to sing with Willie Nelson on his 2002 Great Divide CD was a no-brainer.
I said, well, yeah, of course. I didn't even hear the song or anything. And then when I heard the song, I thought, well, how lucky can I be?
Here's this Monday morning feeling washed away. I orchestrated paradise, couldn't make you stay.
The Grammy-winning song was co-written by producer Matt Serletic and legendary songwriter Bernie Taupin, celebrated for his many hits with Elton John.
My husband, Frank, was just like through the roof over the fact that he had written this song.
Willie did an exceptionally good job with that, I thought. Added to by a girl that can sing.
They said, don't try to out Willie, Willie. Just sing. And they were riding those horses and in the video, and I was, oh, it was so cool. The song was just cool to me. I can remember sitting on that horse, going toward the Capitol, looking over at Willie and just thinking, oh, buddy, I'm the luckiest girl in Texas in the world. That's pretty thrilling to turn on the radio and hear your voice with Willie Nelson. I mean, that's the thrill.
And now, a young John Rich gets carried away with his favorite duet. You're the reason
I met Oklahoma. I actually met a girl at a 4-H camp that was from Oklahoma.
And how'd that go?
It went pretty good. Had this little crush on her, you know. And then not long after that, You're the Reason God Made Oklahoma came out on the radio, and I recorded it off the radio and mailed it to her and learned how to play it. And then I sent her a copy of it, singing it. And then the very first talent contest I ever entered, I sang it. Not thinking that I had to sing the part of the Shelley West part.
So, John, were you singing the Shelley West part?
I sang it. That's back before I had hair on my legs. I could hit those notes.
Yeah. There's a
picture that I can't live. By 1969, Porter Wagoner and Dolly Parton had become the biggest singing duo in country music. That year, they transformed a song made popular by George Jones into one of their most enduring duets.
Dolly and Porter took Just a Girl I Used to Know, and they did it as Just Someone I Used to Know. Say just someone
I used to know. One of my favorite songs that Porter and I ever did was Just Someone I Used to Know. And of course, I had always loved the song.
The way they worked out their harmonies were so unique. Just a flame that's lost its glow.
If you love to sing, you love to sing that song if you're a harp singer.
They complimented each other so much. The blend was just wonderful.
And it was just a great duet, I thought. And we never got tired of singing it on the shows either. We sang it every night after we recorded it, and people just loved it.
George Jones and Tammy Wynette released Two Story House in 1980. They'd been divorced for 5 years. Well, I've got my story. I used to have me more too. Co-written by Wynette, the song looked back on their ill-fated marriage. Two
Story House. Knowing what was going on and then listening to them sing that song was so realistic.
There's a two-story house. There's his story and her story.
They could verbalize or vocalize their angst in their lives at the time and make it into a hit song.
They set the tone for what country music is supposed to sound like.
They couldn't have done anything bad if they tried.
The song rekindled speculation that maybe George and Tammy were getting back together, but it wasn't meant to be.
A lot of people think that we were crazy in love, as they call it, but I think we were just crazy, period. In a two-story house, how sad it is, we're not alone, in a two-story.
Coming up, Willie and Merle create a legend.
Heavens open up, the angels, you know, it's the reckoning at that point.
When Merle Haggard comes in singing, it is like, oh, it's over now. I got chills just now, see?
And later, Reba does some fast talking.
I had to do some explaining to Kenny Rogers about why I had flipped duet partners on it.
Next thing I know, she's done it with Vince Gill. Wait, what happened to me and you, Reba?
But first, what duo sang I'll Fly Away in the movie Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? Was it the Carter sisters, the Kassoy sisters, Alison Krauss and Gillian Welch, or Sharon and Cheryl White? the answer when CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns. Log on to CMT.com for more of CMT's 100 Greatest Duets. Flip through photos, see artist interviews, and get the latest info and TV listings only at CMT.com.
One act.
One smile.
One meal. One whisper of encouragement. $1.
One phone call.
One blanket.
One friend.
One child.
One man.
One woman.
It adds up.
CMT One Country inspires everyday people to take action in their own community. Log on to cmtonecountry.com for more information. Great works are done by hand.
From food on stovetops to stains in the microwave, everyone's finding new places to clean with the Mr. Clean Magic Eraser. Discover 1,001 places to clean. Pass it on.
You gelling?
No telling how much I'm gelling. You gelling?
You know I'm gelling.
Hey, Ellen, you gelling?
I'm gelling. You want some melon?
Nah, but hey, I'm like mud gelling. I'm so gelling.
Nice.
Are you gelling yet? Dr. Scholl's massaging gel insoles are made from the softest gel ever created. If you and your shoes don't feel outrageously comfortable, you get your money back. Guaranteed.
I'm gelling.
You're not gelling.
You're so not gelling.
Are you gelling? Dr. Scholl's.
On September 27th, get ready.
This could be a lot worse. They had this giant hammer.
To join the party.
Yeah, baby.
And celebrate with the coolest DVD of the year.
Yahoo!
Robin Williams is back.
Ta-da!
You missed a spot.
Get out of my room!
I'm not in your room.
I am now.
No, I'm not.
I am not. Amp.
From the creators of Ice Age.
Who wants to get fixed?
Robots. On DVD September 27th.
Fix my neck.
Dell has great deals on PCs waiting for you now. Like this Dimension 2400 desktop. It's yours for $299. Plus, get a free printer. Get more out of now. Dell PCs use Intel Celeron processors.
Don't forget my vitamins.
When was the last time your kids reminded you to give them their vitamins? Now there's Vitaball, the vitamin gumball. A whole new way to take your vitamins. Each with 100% of 11 essential vitamins.
On Vitaball?
Look for it in the children's vitamin section.
So, where are you going to go from here?
Probably the penne with meat sauce. Fettuccine with Alfredo?
I meant with your leg.
It's Olive Garden's never-ending pasta bowl with great new sauces like mushroom Alfredo and creamy five-cheese marinara. Pick one combination of sauce and pasta, then another. Have all you want, just $7.95. Plus, of course, salad and breadsticks.
I'm in a really good place right now, Dad.
At Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
Yeah, Stuart, I know. I got it.
Oh, here's your mail. This too.
Diane, your dog bit the neighbor again.
Frank's freaking out about something.
Diane, this color coding system has color, but it has no code.
An account called either blue or yellow.
Delicious Starbucks Frappuccino coffee drink. It's you time.
It takes a family to make a house a home, and a home to turn a dream into a future. So if you have a dream...
In Chicago, I'm your man. I'm an AmeriQuest mortgage specialist.
So if you're thinking of buying a home or refinancing...
I'll help you pay off your high-interest credit cards and lower your monthly payments.
I'm an AmeriQuest mortgage specialist, and I'm here to help you with your dreams.
Call 1-800-AmeriQuest or visit AmeriQuest.com. AmeriQuest Mortgage, proud sponsor of the American Dream.
When I was a baby, I had a sensitive scalp. Still do. New Head & Shoulders Sensitive Care. Its formula with aloe moisturizes to soothe sensitive scalps, yet still leaves your hair 100% flake-free. Baby your scalp with new Sensitive Care.
What duo sang I'll Fly Away in the movie Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? It was the Kassoy sisters, Irene and Ellen. The identical twins didn't even know their 1956 recording had been used until they saw the movie in a local theater. Alison Krauss and Gillian Welch's version made the Oh Brother CD, but was not used for the movie.
It's a great sentiment.
You know, you think about it, what a great wish.
There is just a feeling behind that song that just makes you happy. Who cares
about the clouds when we're together?
Just sing a song and bring the sunny weather.
Happy. Roy Rogers starred in 88 movies, becoming the number one box office cowboy for 12 consecutive years. On New Year's Eve of 1947, he married his beautiful co-star Dale Evans, also known for writing the duo's theme song, Happy Trails. By the time of their 1950s TV show, they were the most popular cowboy and cowgirl the world had ever known.
He and Dale, I think, were the ultimate good guys.
You had to love Roy Rogers. He was like your best friend or your big brother or your uncle.
When we'd be out at an award show or something, grown men wearing suits and ties, you know, with their eyes tearing up. Roy, just thrilled to meet him.
Roy and Dale were renowned and beloved for more than their public image.
They had their children, and they adopted all of those children. And that what a great story that is.
I remember Roy telling me about visiting the orphanage, and, you know, Dale would always say, now, don't you bring any more kids home. And with a tear in his eye, he said, you know, but there'd always be this one.
Until we meet again.
They represented an incredible optimism, and Happy Trails encapsulates that in an almost perfect way.
Happy Trails!
This song is a perfect example of real country men singing real country songs.
I mean, what a great song. It's still at every honky-tonk in the world you get to, somebody plays that song.
The hook for Good Hearted Woman was inspired by a concert ad Waylon Jennings read in 1969. It said, Tina Turner singing songs about good-hearted women loving good time and men.
And he was like, that's a song. He wrote it.
Well, he actually wrote one line in that song during a poker game they were having.
The teardrops and laughter line, Willie wrote it.
And through teardrops and laughter, they're gonna pass through this world hand in hand.
After the song was finished, Waylon wasn't sure it was strong enough.
He had no confidence in his writing ability, and I said, this is a killer song. And we went to Charlie Pride.
Listen to this song, see what you think you might like. A long time forgot, rain that just fell. I said, oh, yeah, I like it, I like it.
Charlie says, I'll do that. As soon as Charlie said that, Waylon says, well, I thought I was going to do it. He didn't even think he was going to do it until Charlie wanted it.
Waylon recorded it in 1972, scoring a respectable number three hit. But by 1976, when Waylon and Willie were atop the crest of the new outlaw wave, their good-hearted woman duet took on mythic proportions.
She's a good-hearted woman.
When you see them, they are almost married to each other in spirit.
For me, it was an event. It was like Waylon and Willie. They were going to be together anyway, having a good time, so they might as well sing a song.
This good-hearted woman in love with a good time.
And now, a great CMT Crossroads moment.
More than all their clothes.
So truthful, and that's what I love about her music.
Well, you know, I think people just respond to me being open and honest because I accept everything and everybody for who they are.
She made it just for me.
Coming-of-age song, Walk Away Joe, is unforgettable not just because of its haunting melody and storyline, but for the extraordinary vocals by Trisha Yearwood and Eagles lead singer Don Henley.
Tricia Yearwood and Don Henley separately are so incredible, but together they just really have a chemistry that just is magical to me.
That beautiful alto, and then you have Don Henley with his wonderful tenor voice there right on top.
I can't imagine, you know, them sounding as good singing a duet with somebody else, as good as they sound singing together.
That she and I became friends is when I heard her sing. I was just struck. She's just a damn good singer. It's as simple as that.
His softness and raspiness, along with her soulful, rich vocal, was just a magical moment.
I mean, that's a great lyric. It's just heartbreaking, and you know, if you've ever been there, you know what it feels like.
Perfect song, perfect people to sing it, just incredible record.
One of those sounds of a record, their voices together, that's just timeless.
Stop recording session at Willie's studio in Texas. Merle finally gave out and went to bed while Willie continued to look for the perfect duet song for them.
It was about 4 a.m. I'd been in bed about 35 minutes. It was like somebody hit me in the side of the head with a sledgehammer. Somebody woke me up, and it was Willie. And Willie said, he said, I think I found our signature song.
This song fit the two of them, and it was just a perfect marriage.
He said, Towns Van Zandt wrote it. Oh, really?
Towns Van Zandt never wrote a better song than this, in my opinion. I think this is his absolute best, and that's saying a lot.
It tells a heartfelt story, you know, of really love and friendship.
Man, that's just such a haunting song, such a visual song.
Merle Haggard comes in singing. It is like, oh, it's over now. I got chills just now, see?
It's as if heavens open up, the angels, you know, it's the reckoning at that point. He only did what he had to do. And
you know, I did it first, but they had the big hit. But it was okay because it was Merle and Willie.
Everything about it is everyone at their best.
Coming up, two icons come together.
It's a religious experience, you know. You're just so glad it got on record.
It'll just make you go crazy when you hear it.
And later, Brad beats the odds.
The first time I heard it, it just made the hair on the back of my neck stand up.
This will always be one of the proudest moments for me.
But first, what well-known artist sang backup vocals on George Strait's and Alan Jackson's duet, Murder on Music Row? Was it Wynonna, Emmylou Harris, Leanne Womack, or Martina McBride? The answer when CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns.
She has been called the most complete and gifted female singer of her generation. Now, CMT brings you two decades of hits and new songs in an exclusive, intimate performance. CMT presents Wynonna, Her Story.
It's live, baby.
Her Story premieres Friday at 9, 8 Central, only on CMT.
You adore the taste of cinnamon, and you love coffee. What happens when your passions get stirred? Folgers, new cinnamon swirl ground coffee. Try all the tempting varieties of Folgers flavors.
Sit down.
feel like doing now?
I want to sit down.
The ultimate sit-down burger.
Psst, hey, we need to talk.
What's up?
What's up? You're hogging the family again.
We love it out here.
You're already the cooking, heating, hot water guy, but now outside? Aren't you spreading yourself a wee bit thin?
Not at all. Hey, why don't you join us out here?
What? And end up like wood?
I'm too smart for that.
Turn your yard into an outdoor family room with propane and add value to your home. Learn more at usepropane.com.
There's only one way to get hair color like this. Garnier Nutrice. Rich, luscious, nourishing color. Because only Nutrice nourishes with grapeseed and avocado oils. Garnier Nutrice. Nourished hair, better color. Garnier.
We started it. We're ending it. September 30th is your absolute last day to get Chevy employee pricing for everyone on most 05 and 06 full-size trucks. From the family of Chevy trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road, and the number one selling cars, trucks, and SUVs in America. Right now, get a 2006 Silverado 1500 regular cab WT for under $16,200. See your local Chevy dealer.
Body can follow the beat, lead the race, move mountains too. It's wonderful what your body can do if you've a mind to let it. Even bladder weakness just takes a bit of poise. And now there's a new Poise panty. Hugs your every curve, follows your every move, absorbs your every worry. The new panty. This body can set the pace. Poise, yes I can.
To keep this fella out of the doghouse, you need Bounty, the quicker picker-upper. Just one sheet absorbs faster, so it won't drip like this. Bounty.
Hey, Mitch. Want to smell my cast? You've lost a powerful ally.
Imagine if you were like Mitch and had access to a million songs.
Say, Mitch, you think I can get those status reports I asked for?
Shut up, just shut up, shut up.
Mitch, I'm serious.
Shut up, just shut up, shut up.
With Napster's 30-day free trial, you can be like Mitch. That's unlimited access to a million songs, free to check out for 30 days. It's easy. Just sign up at Napster.com/TV. Remember, 30 days is just the start to a whole lot of music.
What day today is? It's a Wednesday!
Discover all the music you want at Napster.com/TV.
Tonight at CMT, don't miss the 100 Greatest Duets concert. Then Bon Jovi and Sugarland meet at the Crossroads. And later, it's CMT Insider.
What well-known artist sang backup vocals on George Strait's and Alan Jackson's Murder on Music Row? When George and Alan were in the studio recording the hit duet, they invited a very excited Leanne Womack to sing along with them.
It doesn't get any better than this. I was really, really thrilled to do it.
In 1993, Vince Gill agreed to duet with his buddy Reba McEntire, knowing full well it might mean appearing in one of her epic music videos.
I get this script in the mail, and I'm going to be a Marine, and I'm going, oh, great, Gomer Pyle jokes for the rest of my life. Sure enough, it all came true.
He did it willingly. He was always acting like Gomer Pyle instead of the, you know, hardcore sergeant he was supposed to be.
The world's fattest Marine in history was me.
Despite Vince's lack of enthusiasm for acting, this Grammy-nominated duet went straight to number one in 1993. Reba and Vince were a perfect fit.
This is one of those songs where you believe that they were a couple. You know, they just had that chemistry.
His voice blends very well with mine and mine with his.
The Reba-Vince duo almost didn't happen. Initially, Reba was to duet with Kenny Rogers. When that fell through, she planned the song as a solo. it was only at the last moment that Vince was added.
I had really even forgotten about that being a possible duet with Kenny and myself.
Next thing I know, she's done it with Vince Gill. Wait, what happened to me and you, Reba? Where'd we go here? Where'd we go wrong?
I had to do some explaining to Kenny Rogers about why I had flipped duet partners on it.
But, you know, Vince happens to be one of my favorite singers. He's got this wonderfully, lyrically pure voice. And then Reba, of course, is a buddy of mine for years and years. I was really happy for him.
Kenny was very understanding and understood, and we went on with it, and Vince was very nice to sing with me.
The truth of it is, I'd do anything she ever asked me to do. I respect and love her that much.
Great melody and a perfect duet.
I'm a little disappointed. We could have done a three-way thing on that so easy.
Sparks were flying in the sizzling 1996 duet by Trisha Yearwood and Garth Brooks.
He knows how to command, and there is a thing, a body language, the way that he stares into the camera, the way that he just commands, and people love that.
Trish Yearwood's not a mean town slouch either, because I'm like one of her biggest fans.
When you look into Garth's eyes when you're watching this music video, you see the intensity, you see the fire in him.
When that song came out, it was like, oh, it just broke my heart, you know, in such a good way.
Imagine what went down in the studio that day. It must have been pretty intense.
The fiery duet was a Grammy-winning performance for the duo. 13 years later, the collaboration struck a more personal note when Garth proposed to Trisha.
You know, they could collaborate forever and a day now.
Well, you know, it was love at first duet. In another's eyes.
And now, Tift Merritt gets an early Christmas present.
Probably my favorite moment of my career was I did a Landmark concert benefit with Emmylou Harris, and I was in my hometown, and I was singing a song, and all of a sudden I heard Emmylou Harris chime in, and I thought, oh my gosh, Emmylou Harris is singing with me. And then I thought, oh my gosh, she knows the words to my song. How did this happen? I came off stage and had this huge smile on my face, and it was Christmas time, and my mother said, well, you don't get anything else for Christmas because you just got everything you wanted. Virginia, no one can
walk. In a pawn shop in Chicago on a sunny summer day.
I went over looking for songs before the session that day, and they played me all kind of things, and they just didn't seem to hit home. And he jumped up from his desk and said, wait a minute, I just thought of something. Let me run back here and see. Golden rings with one tiny little stone. I said, that's the song. That's what we need.
Golden Rings is another classic. For Tammy Wynette and George Jones.
Golden Rings was the first song that they did after they had broken up.
It just told this story of a wonderful thing and of love and marriage and naturally it didn't work out. He said she won't admit it, but
I know you leave in town. Tammy said one thing's for certain, I don't love you anymore.
Actually, we were just telling maybe our story and everybody else's, a lot of other people's at the same time, you know.
When an artist is brave enough to record a song that's hitting so close to home, it's pretty impressive.
Anytime you
hear people sing, and there's more to the story than what's on the record, it piques your curiosity.
Everybody became connected with not just the songs that George and Tammy did, but their life, and then they were able to find and do songs that seemed to tell their story.
In a pawn shop in Chicago, on a sunny summer day.
That's what makes a hit song, is things that happen every day of everybody's lives.
And there you have it. That's how you make a hit.
That's quintessential George and Tammy.
Go.
Charles and Willie Nelson got together. There's a magic. Both of these guys are stars beyond stardom.
Absolutely. One of my favorite records. An Oscar should have been given for that.
Every time the Ray Charles part would start, you know, I'd run it back and listen to that over and over and wore out the tape listening to Ray Charles.
Him and Willie's voices together in that song, it'll just make you go crazy when you hear it.
Come on, Willie, help me with this thing.
That were in that song are the kind of stuff that songwriters strive for every day.
It was almost like a spiritual song, you know, it's kind of like a hymn.
It's a religious experience, you know. You're just so glad it got on record.
Start out with a great song and then you get two great artists singing together, and sometimes it's just a timeless piece of art.
I think that when a singer or musician dies, I have this vision of Ray and several others being those seven Spanish angels at the altar of the throne.
When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. Seven Spanish angels took another angel.
Coming up, Tim and Faith make their mark.
It was our song without me even being on it.
From the beginning, I thought that it was perfect for a single. I mean, it just made perfect sense. And thank God she agreed.
I feel like it was a gift given to us, honestly.
They're our new George and Tammy.
But first, what famous duet partners sang at the 2003 Kennedy Center tribute to Loretta Lynn? Was it Tim and Faith, Garth and Trisha, Kenny and Dolly, or Vince and Reba? Find out when CMT 100 Greatest Duets returns. Log on to CMT.com for more of CMT's 100 Greatest Duets. Flip through photos, see artist interviews, and get the latest info and TV listings only at CMT.com. CMT presents the greatest duets ever with Dolly Parton, Kenny Rogers, Montgomery Gentry, Shooter Jennings, Clint Black, Marty Stewart, and more. CMT 100 Greatest Duets Concert, next, only on CMT.
What can enhance your color? Day after day, Pantene Expressions for brunettes, blondes, and reds. ChromaShine Pro Vitamin formulas infuse every strand with healthy multidimensional shine, enhancing your color every day. Pantene Expressions for brunettes, blondes, and reds. Radiate, glow, shimmer. That's the beauty of health.
Feeling excluded, left out, think you haven't got what it takes, think again. This is the Kia Spectra.
And the Spectra 5, cars you can all get into. Everyone has the right to a 10-year warranty and 6 airbags.
No one should accept less from the man.
People, it's 2005, the velvet rope has come down.
The Kia Spectra.
Spectrum, at a price everyone can get into. Starting around $11.5 after cash back.
Introducing Almay Intense Eye Color. Shadow, liner, and mascara in expertly coordinated shades for your eye color. It's the color of your eyes, intensified. Only from Almay.
Why take your family to a casual dining restaurant and pay $8 a person when you can get the same quality meal for half the price at KFC? Get 10 pieces of Kentucky Fried Chicken, 2 large homestyle sides, and 4 biscuits for less than $4 a person. Your dollar goes further at KFC.
Hotels, you'll earn a free night after just 2 separate stays with choice privileges. For reservations, visit choicehotels.com. Choice Hotels, we'll see you there.
Brooks and Dunn Hillbilly Deluxe CD at Target.
Well, it wasn't until Hurricane Charlie was over the real danger began.
I'm State Farm Agent Dan Mann, and this is a true story.
I'm a diabetic, and so when the power goes out, that's real bad.
His insulin had to stay cold.
He brought me ice.
Plus a check for emergency living expenses.
Before my neighbor even heard from his insurance company. And with all the thousands of people that needed help down here, I felt like their only one.
When you need someone most, nobody takes care of you like State Farm.
We'd love to prove it to you. Call an agent today.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Looking for the perfect snack? The Frito-Lay Variety Pack. Right snacks, right size, guaranteed fresh.
Our dry weave is softer than ever, and it helps keep you dry. Because if you're gonna sit on it all day, it better be comfortable. Have a happy period. Always.
What famous duet partners sang at the 2003 Kennedy Center tribute to Loretta Lynn? It was Garth and Trisha. To honor Loretta, they sang Louisiana Woman, Mississippi Man, the signature song of Loretta and her longtime duet partner, Conway Twitty.
She put him out like the burning end of a midnight cigarette.
Perfect blend with Alison Krauss and my friend Brad Paisley.
His voice and Alison's voice, the way they blend on it, it's beautiful. It's just beautiful.
She brings with her this sort of wonderful ancient tone to her voice.
The first time I heard it, made the hair on the back of my neck stand up.
Absolutely kills me, that song. I just think it's magic.
The song that seems like magic today, however, was pitched around Nashville by songwriters Bill Anderson and John Randall for years with no takers.
There was a lot of interest at first, I think just because it was just shocking enough. I think everybody was scared to death of it.
I remember just being blown away by it, and I took it home thinking, you know, this is a song about suicide.
It wasn't the type of thing we ever thought would be a single.
I remember we got to the second verse and we were thinking, so do we kill her too, you know? And he goes, well, hell yeah, it's country music, you know?
Concerned with the song's dark subject matter, Brad and his producer hit upon a plan. Add a female voice to sweeten the bitter lyrics.
The perfect voice for that was Alison Krauss, because this is somebody who sounds angelic.
But nobody knew how much she blamed herself.
That was a brilliant idea to have an actual angel come in and sing on it, sing the whiskey lullaby.
She tried to hide the whiskey on her breath.
When Alison comes in, it's like so overpowering.
This will always be one of the proudest moments for me, having gotten, first of all, to sing with Allison, but second of all, to just have had this song on the radio.
To me, it goes down in my history book as one of the greatest duets of all time.
La 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 la.
Dancing in the dark,
taking your
middle of the night. Oh,
my gosh. Emotional touch, touching my skin.
We didn't know what the song was going to do or you know, the impact that it would have on the fans, but we certainly felt the impact it had on us before we cut it.
So she was sitting there listening to it. And when I heard it right away, we both were crying.
It was our song without me even being on it.
From the beginning, I thought that it was perfect for her to sing. I mean, it just made perfect sense. And thank God she agreed.
So I ran over and put a harmony on it, and that the rest is the rest is history. It's your love. It just does something to
Your Love became a phenomenon, raking in awards like Song of the Year, Top Country Video, Top Vocal Event, and Single of the Year. It also set off a wave of Tim and Faith mania that's still rolling.
The fairy tale is wonderful. Everyone just kind of got swept up in it with them. It's powerful. Love is powerful.
That is the super couple of country, and has been for quite some time.
They're our new George and Tammy.
First thing we ever did together, and the song that took both of our careers to another level, so that song will always be special.
I feel like it was a gift given to us, honestly.
And now, stay tuned for the CMT 100 Greatest Duets concert hosted by Terry Clark and Trace Adkins, with performances by Clint Black, Montgomery Gentry, Dolly Parton, Kenny Rogers, Travis Tritt, Leanne Womack, and many more. The top 12 greatest duets are coming up next.
You know, and the funny thing is this won't even be on there.
The stage turns, and all of a sudden, here's me and Little Richard going, woo! You know?
I don't know how to talk about this.
John Denver, don't get me started. Thank God I'm a country boy.
Who ever thought of that? I was completely crazy.
Dolly. Why have you never done an album titled Dolly Parton's Biggest Hits?
Dolly Parton! I'd tell her over and over again how much I loved her. I'd be like, I just love you, I love your music, and I love your voice.
And he'd walk up onto the stage and turn the pole out because there were strippers on before us.
I love your outfits, I love your fingernails.
It's just he's so tall, and I'm so short.
Can I serve you dinner? Can I babysit your chicken?
When you say yes to Julio or Willie, you're probably not expecting a lifelong thing.
Look at Ricky Skaggs. What a genius. Look at the... He was married to Amy Grant.
Vince.
Oh, I'm sorry, Vince. I couldn't remember your name. But it's not your fault. I can't remember my name.
I got to be on Sesame Street, and I got to sing with Big Bird.
Miss Piggy wouldn't work with me.
Oh, wah, wah.
And each other, and each other, and each other. I'll say that again.
Duet is derived from the Greek word duet, which means two. All right, we can end now. They want me to leave.
Okay, this is the last time we're ever going to tell this story.